Hello. I am streaming, and that means it is playoff time, baby. And semifinals between Fudgy's Feeders and oh. I might be streaming on the wrong channel. We are live. Okay. Okay. We are live. Okay. Weird, champ. Alrighty. So we are live with the semifinals as I'm being distracted by messages. And I'm going to get some of this music up here. Semifinals between Fudgy's Feeders and Bungs Only Fans. And that is an exciting matchup here. I think these two teams match up incredibly closely. They both have that carry split pusher in the top lane, Garfield Juice versus OG Philman, and then the big matchup of the evening is going to be the match between our two star junglers of the league, Washing Hands and Maye, or will it be Maye? It's hard to tell. Hard to tell who's going to show up tonight between those two. In the mid lane, it's going to be Fleeing Panda versus DTC Ryder, and then in the eight bot lane, Super Hoagie paired up with Hodor Nation up against Clumsy Chocobo and Young Gun 18, set up to be a banger of a match as the perennial top tier pick of this season so far in the ADC role is first picked on blue side for Fudgy's Feeders. Looking at these bans, we see the Respect, Viego, and Graves bans, and we do not want to let Fleeing Panda get that Lux. On the other side, pretty much all Maye bans, saying you're going to have to win through Maye, or you're going to have to win through other means besides the traditional Maye champs. I mean, there are a couple other ones he could play, but they're just kind of trying to take those options away from him. It's going to be very exciting. As I now put on some LEGO Legends music so we could to LEGO Legends with. And the Blitzcrank Ash picked up for Young Gun. That is one of his, that is his main, I believe. Young Gun 18, the Blitzcrank, and the Ash here for Clumsy Chocobo. Already got some good pick potential. Someone on a comfort pick and engage in the bot lane. That said, they do give counter pick over for the support role. Hodor Nation plays, I believe he plays Morgana. That's the one we usually see, but honestly, anything is available. And of course, DTC Riders Aurelion Soul. They said that you left up his main, a champ we don't see too often ever in PMALCS. And they're going to play it here in that matchup into Fleeing Panda and a Braum to kind of keep that safe. Hodor Nation has played that a couple times, I believe, the split. So already, a lot of disengaged, good, solid Braum to peel things off in case he gets hooked or to kind of avoid some of these engages with that shield. An Aurelion Soul to kind of create that pressure from the mid lane and aid Maye on his ganks. I'm not too familiar with these two teams, to be quite honest. So, I mean, I know the general styles are going to play with, but in terms of their champion pool, so it's going to be very interesting and fun to see what they pick here and what they're going to use. And it's an Elise pick we are hearing. That is not a Braum. That is an Elise. I feel. Right? I don't know what's going on here. And we do see the J4. That is a Guy Fieric pick. That is something he definitely would play top. And the Kled, of course, OG Philman special. Oh! Elise is Washing Hands champion. That no pick there on Bungs Only Fans account, that is Elise. So we're going to have an Elise there. I'm going to actually mark that here. Actually, no, it's not worth the time, but that is Elise. So we see Elise. So that's a lot of pick comp. That is just Bungs OnlyFans account is making a huge pick comp. And the now I would say epitome of PMA LCS picks has become a very big power pick this season. The Veigar coming in for Fleeing Panda, going to sit there and farm up. Aurelion still is going to be able to get the roam on him, but he's going to be happy and just farm up, take those plates, and scale up. The Gnar coming in for Guy Fieric in the top lane, and a Nocturne is the pick for Maye to try and run down this Ashe and Veigar through that baby cage. So, and the Gnar engaged, if they could play around that Gnar ultimate, the Mega Gnar's bar, it's going to help them a lot. What is Garfield Juice's answer? Not gonna probably not be the Ornn, maybe the Sejuani. The Sion is the answer into the Gnar for Guy Fieric. So these two top laners known for just wanting to split push. Guy Fieric, of course, really likes being that tanky boy. So yeah, it's gonna be a fun time here. Again, both these teams have very similar playstyles. Their bot lanes kind of just do their things and scale up to carry in the mid to late game, but most of the action is funneled through that top laner split, get the top laner set up for a split push, and their junglers being their primary carries. Maye put onto this Nocturne after getting five bans sent his direction. Super exciting. You know what I just realized? I did not drop the message on Facebook here that we got finals between there we go. Drop that. Boom. Okay, now we're ready to go. That is our Veigar mid. Right now we have some biology occurring on the side of Fudgy's feeders. Trying to ice them out right before the games actually start. Whoops. Yeah, it's going to be a very exciting series. So, talk about the matchups here. I'm not the most familiar with a lot of the lane matchups, but I can theorize. So, we'll start from the core of these teams, this jungle matchup. The Elise versus Nocturne are honestly kind of diametrically opposed in terms of their goals. Or at least you would see on face value. Goals in the early game, they're opposed. But in terms of goals when we get to mid-game skirmishes, and even kind of into the late game, they have fairly the same goal, which is going to find a squishy, pick them off. On the side of the Elise, they're going to be trying to find Jinx or Aurelion's Soul, get that cocoon, set up the play, help the pick with the Blitzcrank and the Ashe. I mean, this is a pick comp from Bungs OnlyFans account that got kind of shifted into more of a team fight disengage situation with the Veigar and the Sion in the end. But the Elise is going to be definitely want to kind of finding those picks on the side. Nocturne also wants to go and get the squishies. He wants to ult in, find this Ashe, find this Veigar, and make them miserable so they have to run away from him the whole game, much like the Elise wants to do to the other side. However, how they do that is different, where Elise wants to kind of play off to the side, find a cocoon angle. Nocturne just says, bet, R, time to go in with Spell Shield. That said, they both also are going to thrive, and this is where these picks are going to be very interesting in this matchup. They're going to thrive off of catching these split-pushing top laners, which kind of leads into top lane. OG Philman and Guy Fieric, two of the strongest top laners in this split, both like to split push. Like, I mean, the big meme is Fudgy always has Guy Fieric build the Hull Breaker because memes, I guess. I mean, it's a very efficient item, jokes aside. And so they're going to want to split push at each other a lot, which is going to set up some great action in that top lane because they're going to be splitting. Nocturne loves to catch a split pusher out of position with that ult. Elise, very good for the spider movement speed to go up and set up that pick with the cocoon on a split pusher on the side. So both of those picks kind of play into what both these teams do in this sort of mirror matchup. The interesting wrinkle on that is actually going to be coming from this mid lane matchup. We talked about in the draft how Veigar, unless he goes Predator, which I would like to see Fleeing Panda do, is going to just kind of stay set in place, keep stacking and farming mid. Where Aurelion's Soul is going to get the push in and then use his E, I don't quite remember what it's called, to go zoom into another lane and cause some havoc and basically be a secondary jungler along with Maye. But with recent changes in the way the recent meta for Veigar has been, with the Predator being an option that is available to him, he can also technically match those roams. Not as good as Aurelion's Soul, but he can also apply that pressure. And honestly, Predatoring in and then dropping the baby, it almost guarantees a good baby cage. So we can. So that's why I would like to see Fleeing Panda do that, to kind of match the roam pressure that's going to be coming from Aurelion's Soul. And then bot lane, one hand you have Farmfest Extreme and the other one, pretty decent laning power with the Blitzcrank and the Ashe. Ashe is going to want to just kind of push him in, trade autos with the slow, and then get the hook and just kind of keep him in that situation. Though the counter engage in that bot lane from the Braum passive is kind of fun. It's going to create some interesting situations there. Really fun draft, I think, but the jungle picks are going to prey on what both top laners want to do, which would be very fun. It's a very interesting matchup overall. I think if I were to give the edge to anyone in just draft alone, I would say purely off of the meme, but also it is PMALCS, teams tend to get a real scrappy around objectives and getting a good objective setup, which is where Veigar thrives. A pick like Blitzcrank thrives, just kind of find that hook, or Veigar dropping the baby cage, preventing the rest of your team from being able to go in, denying this Gnar that engage he wants to have. And so, like, Veigar is just the perfect PMALCS pick, much like how Sivir has been forever. Just perfect to play around, scales for free as the game goes on, and games do go long, especially with how scrappy both these teams are. Same with the Scions, also really good in those situations. So that's just for the tendency of PMALCS. I think those last two champs from Bung's only fans account does kind of tilt it in their favor. That said, I think early games can go in Fudgy's Feeder's favor off of the Aurelion's Soul. But it is in the first kind of six levels in the jungle, it's on Aurelion's Soul to create that pressure on the map. And it doesn't have to be he actually goes to a lane as much as like, yo, a soul's missing from his lane, be careful. Just that hidden pressure. You know, like you watch a lot of good Galio players, they'll push in and they'll just disappear into Fog of War, literally sitting under their tower or clearing a ward, but the team's terrified because they're level 6 and could be there. It's kind of that vibe, and then eventually you do make your move. So it's going to be kind of reliant on DTC Rider having that pressure, and then when Nocturne gets 6, that's when sparks are going to fly. But Elise has this really powerful window before that Nocturne is 6 to impact the map. There's my word vomit. Vague Dan, I am solo casting as of right now. I believe I should have Bear with me, but I'm not quite sure. So I'm just vibing. I am no alien to the solo cast life. Wait, is it not actually showing the client? What? Where is the client? Yeah, it should be showing. Huh, guess you'll never get to see client ever again. That's fun. We are a minute away from loading in for the semifinal match. The winner of this is going to play the winner of last night's semifinals, which is Mung. It's my team. And I can't remember what Mung stands for. You can get it or something like that. It's really funny. I swear it is funny. Trust me. Yeah, the only dive buddy from with the Nocturne here is the Gnar, which is why that baby cage comes in. Yeah, like you said, mini Narc. Yep. Pretty much the point I was gonna say is the Gnar needs to be able to get in there along with maybe the Aesol.
True. The Jinx, no, the Jinx is the kind of counter AoE team fight pick to the Veigar. It's gonna be very fun. Oh. My door is loud.
And my cats
say hello. Alrighty. Loading screen coming up here. Gonna be a very exciting series. Prove yourself and rise! So which of these two teams will rise up and meet the challenge in this best of three series? Playoffs are very exciting. Okay. Getting the big black screen treatment from League. There we go. Indeed, we do see the Predator from Veigar, from Fleeing Panda on the Veigar. That is good. Try and keep up with that roam from the Aurelion Soul. I think that's very smart. We do see Cleanse coming in from the Aurelion Soul. Not want to deal with a lot of that CC. Actually, it's a lot of Cleanse on the side of Fudgy's Feeders. Oh my gosh, I got the... It's going to be OG Philman on the Scion. I got the names wrong. I am so sorry. Guy Fieri going to be with the Gnar. I was talking about the analysis from the teams from the right side. I just got the top laners mixed up. Mung won the series last night, Neil, and it was a very exciting one. Overlay is borked on loading screen only, I swear. But what is extra borked is spectator not working. We are very familiar with this bug here. So give me 1 second. Because I act that will not, the spectate will just not play, and it's the worst. So yeah, just as a note to the, I'm hoping if like maybe some of the team managers are listening in, please, when you make those lobbies, keep spectating open, because this is what, it's just a big mess, and you saw that bug. But we're loading in for realsies, lethal tempo on the Jinx. Guiding on the Braum. Glacial Augment Blitzcrank. I'm not too familiar with that one, but I mean, it makes sense. Like Glacial Augment has for everyone. I'm very excited. I will say, I'm sad to see Washing Hands. Well, Washing Hands being honorable, not using a cheater skin. Though I'm not familiar with that skin on Elise, so maybe it's a cheater skin, but Blood Moon Elise, kind of a cheater one because you can't really see the cocoon. That's why I use it. I don't like using brain cells. Alright, we do see the four-man stack here. OG Philman on that Scion, chilling at the top side. Blitzcrank, four-man stack, pretty standard. Very odd to not see anyone cover mid here. But didn't want to have the... There is an option Blitz champs like Blitz and Nautilus can do where they just sprint down mid and hook the first person you see mid lane. Try and get a sum out of them. Here comes Blitz, sees Aurelion Soul, pings go out, OG Philman finds himself two friends, and desires no such friendship, and the two wards coming in from these junglers, so they know where people are starting. No, did Maie ward? Maie did not ward. He's faking the ward, making it seem, yeah, you can see the ping, so faking the ward, basically trying to bait the Elise to start bot in a way, make him think it's warded out. Some mind games here, or honestly just trying to troll. You never know. It's Maie. Alrighty. So what we're going to probably see from the Elise is three camps into gank, or we might even see five camps into a gank, but odds are it's going to be three camps into a gank. Buff, grump, buff. Oh, they did get... Yeah, there's a red ward. They're trying to stop the invade on the top side. Nocturne's going to be going into a full clear angle here. The question is, does he go for a vertical jungle, or is he going to just walk down to the bot lane, just kind of happily full clear. They do know Nocturne has started top based off those wards on the red buff. So the first interesting decision of the game for junglers is here, and that is Elise going into the five camp clear. So she's going to be ganking roughly around 3 to 315, as opposed to going for a much earlier 230 to 245 gank with the three camps. Young Gun. Clumsy Chocobo here. Who gets level 2? Young Gun and Clumsy Chocobo do, and they're already trying to force him away. The slow's coming in from Ash. Young Gun is looking for that angle instead. He's just going to give him the good old fist. Glacial Augment getting the slow. Hooder Nation flashing away. Gets hooked again. The other get the stun onto Blitzcrank. Heal is going to keep him alive. That is first blood going to Young Gun. 18 good on them using, like we talked about pre-game, Ash is going to want to get that push in, out of them, weaken them down, and then make, to get their level 2 advantage, and they played it beautifully to get first blood down that bot lane. Elise opting into 4 camps, which is fine. You often will see junglers, at least in this league. I don't watch enough professional play this split to season to really know, but we see a lot of brothers in this league. No, he's going 5 camps. He just wants the red buff for the Raptors. That makes sense. Okay, okay. But you do see a lot of people do the 4 camp into scuttle into the rest of their clear. I personally find it a bit odd, but this makes a lot more sense. The red buff kind of helping with Raptors, at least having a hard time with the camp. Maya is finishing up his full clear, which is what you expect in this matchup. A little bit slow. I think Notron can do that leashless at like 315 as Guy Fieri jumping into OG Philman using that hyper from Gnar, but the shield damage is immense from OG Philman, making Guy Fieri want to reconsider his actions. But here comes Elise with the rappel down. Guy Fieri flashing out immediately. Flash Q coming from Washing Hands. That execute is going to finish off Guy Fieri for the two first kills here, going in favor of Bung's OnlyFans. And that is a 1,000 gold lead. All in this Blitzcrank and Elise. Nocturne going to get the Scubble Crab and set up some good vision for his bot lane. Waiting for that 410 timer where the Gromp respawns right now. You can see that ping going out. Get the counter jungling in. He's just, again, trying to hard farm to 6. It's like we talked about before the game started. Ooh, almost got the hook under the tower. Hoder Nation's got to be very careful. This is Elise's biggest power point against the Nocturne are these first few minutes here. Taking the most out of, getting the most advantage she can out of that Washing Hands, getting that kill top to kind of snowball her a bit so then she can impact the map. We see her going Hextech Alternator. 9 of gold for Sork Shoes. Going the Dark Seal to try and really snowball the game. There are a lot of Elise players, myself included, who like to go Sork Shoes because of that big movement speed to really move around the map fast and do what you need to do. And she also has enough front end, like, just damage in her kit. But I like the Dark Seal. With the Hextech Alternator going to try and hard snowball that, try and take advantage of this moment. Nocturne's going to be 6 very quick soon here after his next clear. Elise taking this bot pressure that they have created to try and do a dragon. Just doing it on spot sight with that Scuttle Crab vision there. Because they got the mid prio with that big wave pushed in. They have the bot prio off the kills and this big wave pushing in. So of course we're going to get this dragon. Scuttle Crab vision be damned. Again, taking advantage of this early game from the Elise as we see Guy Fieri just poking out OG Philman. Gets the jump interrupted. Tanks 2 tower shots from that incredibly long stun. The slow coming out from the boomerang. OG Philman getting the grass proc for the damage of the shield popping with the solo kill. Unfortunate for Guy Fieri, but a great interrupt from OG Philman on that jump. Really, really well played to time that Q release. Kind of sensing the future there. Meanwhile, this bot lane from Hoagie Hodor Nation, even in CS, despite that first kill, Jinx is their late game carry. Now, we do see DCC Ryder has not made a move on the map. That's another one of the things we talked about, is how DCC Ryder is going to want to play to kind of be the jungler in these first few levels before Maye is level 6. And we haven't quite seen that too much. Now, we did see the first question mark ping coming out of Veigar just a second ago. You know, that hidden pressure, Aesol is missing. Oh, no. Woo! Almost walking into that hook bot. Washing Hands is down here. Nocturne is not level 6 yet. He is so close. Got to be a camp or a couple minions away. No, yeah, it's about a 1 camp away. Looking to try and find a way to get that experience points. May sit here on the side of the lane here. Do a walk-in gank. Elise is down here. Oh, we're about to have some fancy feet here. Maya does get the fear in there before. Gets the face check from Washing Hands, who has to rappel to safety. Young Gun knocking up Maya. Here is Braum to save the day. Washing Hands going to get healed up by his bot laner. Young Gun is going to be left for dead as Super Hoagie has gotten the kill. The chase is on as Washing Hands is down under 200 health. Rocket 1, Rocket 2, surely going to come out. The Braum ram does not connect. Hoagie might not have been in range to finish that kill off, or maybe even trying to give the kill to someone. Hodor Nation getting chased down by Clumsy Chocobo, who's dissuaded by the Nocturne Q, and they walk away with only 1 kill, but Washing Hands getting red a little bit there by Maya, expecting some shenanigans down bot, calling it correctly and punishing the face check. Oh, Oh, Vygar stun coming through. We do not see DCC Cleanser holding onto it, trusting in his own stun there, and it's paying off dividends. Again, DTC Rider has these Sork Boots first, should be trying to push the Vygar in and make a move on the map, but now the Vygar has lost Chapter. You can kind of WQ to push back pretty effectively. But I'd like to see the Aurelion still be a bit more active on the map. Use that E. All right, time to learn what that E button is called. Comet of Legend. Oh, Elise looking mid here. They do have dive potential. Going to get the stun to Vygar, but trapped him in the baby cage. He's going to have to juke out the cocoon. Instead, opts to flash away from that situation. Despite the kills and the pressure up top, we do see Guy Fieric is only down 10 CS. Oh, here comes Nocturne punishing the over-aggressiveness of OG Philman despite the vision there. Flashes in front of him to interrupt the ult out to safety, and that is a kill for Guy Fieric. Maie's time is here. The Nocturne has hit level 6, and we're going to start seeing him making big moves on this map. Again, another thing we talked about before the game started is both these teams have very aggressive top laners that want to dominate their opponent and set up a strong split. OG Philman thought he was safe with that ward in the River Brush, but that ward is honestly not enough. Generally, when you're like seeing a lot of these junglers on that ward, it's already too late usually, but especially against a Nocturne, you're going to want to ward around this area right here because that's around that range where his level 6 ultimate is going to be able to reach you from, as we saw there. Things are starting to look a little shaky. The Jinx got a kill, kind of negating all that bot pressure they achieved in the first levels. And Washing Hands has been able to snowball with this Dark Seal yet. Still sitting on just that in the Hextech Alternator. Didn't even get to have a clear because after his first back, kind of went bot, got Dragon, and... Oh no, he has a few clears in him. I can't look at CS numbers, I'm dumb. But my level 7 because Washing Hands has been spending his time in lanes, which is what you're going to see from an Elise. Though, this Dragon coming up here, we see Washing Hands getting the Rift. They might try to make a play with Rift Herald to push in a tower into the Dragon. Oh, stun into stun. DTC Rider really, you know, he may not be making the roams on the map, but it seems like he's familiar with this matchup, knowing that when he's getting baby caged, just drop his own stun there to counteract. Washing Hands using the Rift Herald top to try and break it, but gets gnarred into the wall, rappelling out to the blast cone to safety. Gonna look for a cocoon. Gets hit by a building or by an iceberg there. One more iceberg will do it. Guy Fieric gets the kill. But with the gold that has just been traded from that Rift Herald charge, it is even gold exchange. But despite the full metal alchemist equivalent exchange that went down in gold up there, we do see Nocturne looking to make a play down bot, knowing Washing Hands just not responding to Super Hoki. Gets hooked in. He may be dead. He cleanses too early. The Asher is going to get him. Flashes up safety. Clumsy Chocobo gets flashes in to make sure they get the kill on the ADC. It's one for one in the bot lane with the Nocturne. They're going straight for this Dragon. Oh yeah, that Gnar Snipe was from Fog of War too. Good on Guy Fieric. What a fun top lane to watch here. Both of them going for the Hole Breaker nonsense. Red buff on a Gnar against Sion has to feel bad. Washing Hands is here. It's just Totoro Nation and Maie. Vygar is moving in as well. Fleeing Panda is here. Smite fight! Blue team gets it. The Q went onto the Nocturne as the Baby Cage is going to land on a Hodor Nation. He is dead immediately, hooking Maie into it, preventing him from flashing out. He does have his friend Aurelion Soul here, but it's too late. Despite the three-man stun, they get the double kill for Fleeing Panda. And this Vygar is happily scaling his young gun. Running up. Yeah, Vygar this game is just freaking Bob Rossing it. Just painting a happy little scaling picture here. Got the clouds. Got himself a Nocturne. He's happily scaling away. And two kills. 13 CS up. Probably decent stacks. 93 stacks. He is chilling. And this is what we talked about with the Vygar pick, where it's like these fights around objectives that you're going to see in PMA LCS, Vygar thrives. And the way that scrappy games go, Vygar thrives in those situations. My goodness, the red buff is doing so much damage here with the Mega Gnar. OG Philman trying to get himself out alive, looking for an angle to ult out. And Sheds has to flash out, goes for the stun under tower, gets the grass proc, ulting in, is still getting chased down by the Gnar, who's going to flash in. And that is going to be Guy Fieri getting the solo kill top lane. Have to wonder why OG Philman didn't just ult away, but maybe he saw a tower angle there. The tower probably didn't aggro like he thought it was going to. There was only a minion left there. So, despite some of the interesting stuff going bot, we do get the win top lane. Also want to point out the unfortunate Q targeting for Washing Hands, going for that steal for the dragon. He was going for the Q smite, but instead the Q, the execute on the Elise spider form, went onto the Nocturne. So, yeah, that's another thing to keep in mind. Elise will almost always win smite in a straight on, like, smite v smite. Elise is going to win because they took away the level differential in smite last season. Or was that two seasons ago now? And Elise has that execute on her Q. So in theory, she's going to win. Her smite is more effective because she could time it with that Q. Turret plating will fall soon. Oh, we do see... Okay, so we're having a pause here. Yeah, I don't know... yeah, having to do some wrapping. Matt's finger is... he's having to re-up his finger. I don't know how public it is, but injury. This is an injury timeout. While we're waiting here, very interesting early game. A lot of the thing, it's interesting at this point to kind of take, as we begin our transition into the mid game, to take stock of the things we expected to happen in this early game and what has happened. As we begin to get going in, we expected the Elise to make moves while Nocturne's farming to six, which did happen. Nocturne hit six and immediately punished the aggressive top lane, which is, again did happen. Hell, Elise's first gank went to punish the aggressive top laner. We see the Veigar happily scaling and playing around these objective fights. The Ashe Blitzcrank pressure bot, the potential Braum counter engage off the stuns, the Jinx being able to do a lot. The one thing that hasn't quite happened is the DTC Rider on the Cerulean Soul making moves on the map. The only time we see him really trying to move into a skirmish was in that late move to the dragon fight where the Veigar outroamed him. And oh, here, another roam with that Predator. Another thing we talked about early game as the stun goes down. Guy Fieri under half health, but here comes the Nocturne. Can't stop the Primordial Burst as he gets the kill with the ultimate from Veigar. And we have a weird freeze. That is not stream, folks. That is the replay. Okay, we are good. Chase coming in. What a flash from Maya to avoid the knockup by Sion. The OG Philman trying to stay alive using the shield gets feared by Maya. The passive going to heal him up a little bit. Knockup comes in hot. Spell shields the Q from Fleeing Panda. Gets a good baby cage out, and it is one for nothing in this top lane. Really crazy fight as Hook comes in bot lane. Hooder Nation going to get hooked in by Young Gun, but that is what they want. They're going to get the passive onto the Blitzcrank, but the Braum ultimate goes wide, splits the uprights, doesn't matter. Clumsy Chocobo walks onto Chompers. Gale forces into another Chompers. More actually coming up top as the tower goes down, and DC Rider's going to kill OG Philman. We go back to the bot lane as the fight continues, but Super Hoagie seems to be coming out alive. And despite how crazy it was and how close it has been, oh, Young Gun, he's looking for it. Dropping the wards, gotta be fishing, walks up, gets the hook, cleanse early from Super Hoagie, tried to get that Captain Jack cleanse, but doesn't get it, and Clumsy Chocobo gets executed by bot lane tower. Executed. Yeah, Aurelion Soul really popped off in that fight too, absolutely, really tragic they didn't get a kill. I do see Cyan's Ray spawning, so maybe something happened up there that I missed. Yeah, so Aurelion Soul really popping off. DTC Rider, very proficient on this champion. It is his main, which is kind of why I'm sad. Like, we see what happens now. He's being that second jungler with Maya in that fight top, roaming up to follow the Nocturne ult. It'd be really cool to see that earlier, but as we see now, the power of this champion and his proficiency with it. Maya, there's a red ward behind you. Yeah, okay. All right, so now next dragon coming up, 38 seconds. Last dragon led into a crazy little skirmish situation where the Veigar had the first roam, but Nocturne did win the smite. And we see also up there, Fleeing Panda did have the first roam. That's why we talked about how we should take the Predator in this matchup because he can match or even beat out the Aurelion Soul on these roams. setting up, oh my gosh, all this vision, the traditional setup, get the vision control, have them, force them to walk into you and get a hook, just like that young gun was looking for it on Brom, checking where he shouldn't really. And it does appear they might just give up this Drake, knowing they don't have the control, they weren't there in time for the setup. We even see Sion starting up this Rift Herald. Now, that's very risky, trying to get both these objectives at once, because usually you're going to see a team do the cross-map play. As we see Guy Fieri going in, gnarring in, Unstoppable coming out of OG Philman, getting himself to safety, all while Sion yells coward. Hook goes wide, that is their opportunity to strike. Gets the flash of the Gale Force out of Ash. Ash arrow goes down, but it is spell shielded by Maya. Young Gun getting chased down. One more auto would do it. Gets the zap, but not the kill. Jinx Rocket is not available. They used it earlier. So close on these scraps bot. One more auto. 2,000 gold separating these teams, but that is a, could be a canyon here in this early game. Flashes Ash. Oh, they're setting up a dive here, bot. Look at the minimap. Look at the pings. And just and they're going to be trying to make this play. A cross map coming top, going for the Rift Herald at Veigar and Elise. Yeah. Clumsy Chocobo. In Smash Brothers, we saw that emote. In Smash Brothers, we call this taunt to get bodied. Oh, Fleeing Panda here to try and dissuade anything else. Maybe going to get a trap here himself. Bing, bop, boom. No Potter Nation. Still a little bit too tanky to get that. Does have a null magic mantle. Good ever frost proc to give to safety. Young Gun now coming in with blood in his eyes. Hook almost nicking that shield there. Missing by a couple pixels. Yeah, both these teams love to skirmish, so it's going to be a wild ride from here to the next 20 minutes. That's right, I said 20 minutes. We're going to be here for a while. Uh-oh. The hook, the turnaround for the Q. Younga didn't expect it. Gets his knockup spell shielded, and I think he accidentally hit the blast cone. I don't think that was Maya. Really close. They maybe tried to get the Blast Cone into his team there. Guy Fieri chasing down Clumsy Chocobo, who knows he is most likely dead here without a flash. Gale Force goes out, dodges the boomerang, though. And here comes Doctrine on to Fleeing Panda, who's trying to pinch around to Guy Fieri, who gets feared through the Zhonya's. That duration lasts, and the tether lasts throughout the Zhonya's. The fight is split up on two axes here, as Guy Fieri is chasing down Young Gun with the Hyper. Washington uses the Repel to get himself to safety. Now OG Philman is here alone. Guy Fieri goes Meganar, goes in, gnars them both into the wall. No stun, but it is enough to get him back into the team. And that is a two for nothing in this mid lane, and almost certainly this tower going down. The ability to roam from the side lanes, this mobility from the side of Fudgy's feeders coming in, incredibly handy to play off of Guy Fieri's aggressiveness on that chase. They thought they had to pinch with Fleeing Panda there. They thought they had him in their sights, but then Maya coming in with the Nocturnal, DTC Rider, Comet of Legends coming in to save the day and turning that whole situation around. And now, despite being down 2k not too long ago with the shutdown from the Veigar, oh, flash hook. Okay, it just moved left. It moved left to hit that minion. I'm not the only one that saw that. It went forward and then moved left. What was that blitzkrieg? I'm not even mad at Young Gun. Like, that's just insane. I don't think it hits anyone. I just think it's so funny. The hook went boink, bonk. That was hilarious. Oh, jeez. Alrighty. 1,000 gold separates the teams. And 1.5 minutes separate us from another dragon fight, this time for Soul Point. No, the items are not quite online for a 20-minute Baron, which could potentially be an option here from the side of Fudgy's feeders, so we'll see how they opt into this. The pick comp is on Bung's OnlyFans account side here, which means this early setup is 100% in their favor. Speaking of picks, going after Hodor Nation here. Hook does connect, hitting him on that shield. Nocturne ultimate getting set, going on to the Veigar mid lane, catching out the mid laner alone, going to get the kill. We move into this bot mid lane skirmish in the jungle as we see the Meganar coming in hot, getting the kill onto Clumsy Chocobo. Maye gets hooked by the Blitzcrank, who will sacrifice himself for his jungler. And Aurelion Soul DTC Rider just pushing top for free here. And these globals from the Nocturne really making a difference here, punishing the Vigar, who is alone, and Guy Fieric somehow surviving that situation, same with Hodor Nation. Dragon up in 15 seconds, not enough time unless they Filling Panda can make some miracles happen from over the side with the Vigar. Yep. Yeah. Okay. Fun fact. Barely anyone ever checks that bush. If it's Ocean Soul, you can do a lot of shenanigans. I cannot tell you how often I have just blast coned or flashed into that bush to just sneak a smite. It is hilarious. So always check that bush, friends. And now the Baron setup comes into play. One of the things I would like to see is maybe these picks go on to, like, Bungs Only Fans has the right idea. They're getting to these objectives. They're setting up that vision so far in advance. The execution after that point is just not quite there yet. As we see Guy Fieric going into OG film, and these two top laners just battling out for 22 minutes straight, nonstop. Meganar coming through, gets the stun. OG Philman getting ulted into the wall, walking away safely. Knows he's too tanky at this point for that to kill him. Going for the Prowler's Call Hole Breaker build. That's always fun. But yeah, we see Bungs Only Fans account kind of like they're playing for these objectives, like they're setting up for it, but they're not quite completing the execution of the pick itself. The stuff beforehand is there, just not quite the finishing move. And we see them trying to make a play up top. If you looked at the minimap, you saw that Ash Arrow coming through. Here comes Australia's zooming button as they just run up, knock up, bing, bam, bop. Don't even try. Hit the point and click clumsy choke by getting caught up by Hodor Nation. Guy Fieric teleporting into this fight. Kind of alone. Nocturne ult is here, though. Guy Fieric almost Meganar. He does get it, but it is probably not enough as they get the shutdown onto him. Maya is now here going to walk through here. Did not use his ult. Jinx Rocket just going to quickly take out Young Gun. One for one in the top lane right now as the chase continues. Hodor Nation trying to get a flash Q well out of range. Maya deterred. Ooh, flash Gale Force coming in from Super Hoagie. Hodor Nation gets stunned up. Washington's going on the assassination. Oh, does he have the damage? He does to finish off Super Hoagie. So that's ADC for jungler. No Baron is going to be attempted in this situation. Washington's kind of trading himself out to deter that from being the decision. Flame Panda. All right. Hooey. More than a kill a minute here, friends. Man, can you imagine watching the NCAA tournament over this? My goodness. This is much more exciting. Actually, who won the NCAA tournament? Oh. Still in the second half. This is far more exciting. Look at this. They have the Vigar. We have the Jinx. That's Jinx from Arcane, right? Like, who wouldn't be enthralled? That's Blitzcrank from Arcane Season 2. Is that a Diamond 1 player talking in my chat? My goodness, Wordy. Just be quiet. We know you. We know you. We know how... they know Maya's there. He doesn't know they're there. They're going to get the hook, and that it might be a dead jungler, but the Steryx gauge keeping him alive for so much longer. That is a rampage, and what they thought was a good pick may turn out to be against them as DTC Rider's ultimate chunking out the back line here. Double kill for Maya now walking away. Syad is here, but only to get Chain CC'd. Gets the ult, goes on to Super Hoagie and gets the kill. Now, does he finish off Maya? He almost certainly will. 1v4, man-moding it here. He does have his Prowler's Claw. He used that to get in close, however. OG Philman teleporting in and literally just stopping the Baron take there. Oh my gosh. They went for the pick there. They thought they had the damage, and they almost did, but that Steryx gauge keeping Maya alive for so long there with his passive heal, with the two of them around him getting a little bit extra AoE on it. Oh, that's so unfortunate for them. Super close there. The execution was there, just the damage was not there this time. Maybe they had Fleeing Panda. I don't remember if he was there or not to kind of supplement their damage. Ooh, Clumsy Chocobo is bot. looking to play for this drag. I'd love to see Fudgy's feeders. They know they don't. It's not soul point. They know this isn't soul drag. They know. And you just go straight to Baron here. They have the control around Baron. You have the Jinx with two items. You have a Nocturne. Just go to Baron right now. As you know, they're setting up for this dragon. If they see you, you force them to give up the Drake. If they, for a little bit, if they don't. At the end of the day, you're also playing into what they want, which is to hook you walking into this objective here. Yep, some poke coming out from over the wall. Letting the tank's face check so they can clear the wards. But instead, we're going to have a team fight. Oh, there's the hook onto Hodor Nation. Nocturnal going to come into play. Guy Fieri going to get ulted by Ash. The dive's coming through. The baby cage does not stop the Gnar as DTC Rider, Comet of Legend, on the massive flank. And Super Hoagie going to kite out. Oh, he gets killed by the flash from the Scion, but it is not enough. OG Philman actually continuing to go man mode. Might get the kill onto Hodor Nation here. Nope, Hodor Nation noping himself out. And this is going to be the dragon going to Fudgy's feeders. That flank from the Aurelion Soul was enormous. And one of the things predictions we had was this Veigar really setting up strong zones around these team fights. But the Nocturne and the Aurelion Soul the Nocturne, the Gnar, and now the Aurelion Soul have all found themselves angles around that baby cage. This could be a bit too aggressive. They don't have the Jinx damage to play here. They know Fleeing Panda has teleport. He could TP to that pink ward. Maybe poke him out. Looks like they're not opting in to poke him out of the Baron pit from over the side. Too afraid of the turn. Guy Fieri jumps over the wall, looking for another ultimate. Tries to get the stun into Young Gun. Washing Hands is here. There we see Clumsy Chocobo trying to poke him out. Nocturnal comes out. Baron is resetting. Nocturne choosing to go out of Clumsy Chocobo. Goodbye, Julio. And now, reset. We have the Jinx to do the Baron faster. Opting to back here. Guy Fieri does have teleport. Remember, Elise wins smite fights. She has the execute. And that is what they're afraid of. A 50-50 situation where they're at least smiting with an execute. Gonna win the fight there. Oh, Maya doesn't have smite. That's the biggest reason why they're not doing it. You can see he pinged it. Yeah, so... whew. Really lucky. All that, despite not using the Fleeing Panda TP to poke him over the wall, they were able to... honestly, maybe on the play off the over-aggressiveness there, I think they could have finished it. And I think Guy Fieri was trying to zone out the Elise. I'd have to watch the replay. It seemed like he was trying to zone out the Elise, but when they saw that it wasn't quite working as intended, they didn't want to risk the smite fight. Because again, Elise wins that smite. And with the repel, it's like almost impossible to stop her from getting in and being a factor in the situation. And also, Veigar, if he was there, which they don't necessarily know if he might be there or not, Veigar WQ is actually the strongest smite in the game right now, I believe. I wish he got... he went Zhonya instead of Rabadon's... not... yeah, Rabadon's not Randuin's. He would 100% be the strongest smite. Actually, what is that WQ combo sitting at right now for Fleeing Panda? 545, 477. All right, not quite there yet. If he went Rabadon second, he definitely would be at that stage where it's kind of outsmiting things, but the Zhonya is very understandable with this Nocturne in play. Punishing the immobile carries from this Bagoth team. Oh, they're looking for another fight. I mean, it feels as though... I mean, the Elise has definitely got... excuse me, has long been outscaled at this point. Yeah, I feel like going in on OG Philman, two levels up. OG Philman, knowing this might be doomed in another... oh, the Nocturne taking... he doesn't even have to use his ult to take advantage of it. What a good spell shield coming out of Maya there. They're going to try and chase him down here, however. It is 2v4. Nocturnal goes in onto the Ash. Gale forces into the bush trying to save his life, but it does not matter. The healing, that is a death's dance, healing Maya all that damage there. But Washing Hands gets the shutdown. Now they're going on to Guy Fieri. Realizes that Gnar hurts, and the Gnar has Hull Breaker. The stun going to give them a chance to flash to safety. Meanwhile, as that fight was going on, we see Hodor Nation and Super Hoagie just pushing down this mid lane and getting that inhibitor. it is kind of falling apart here for Bung's OnlyFans account here. And going into this late game, they've been outscaled, and the Veigar has not quite reached the items. He has the Anathema's Change, which is going to help. We can see he puts that on. I wonder if it's going to be on the Nocturne or the Jinx. But he's got another one more item. He needs that Rabadon's before he really starts popping people with this build. And Guy Fieri clearly, you know, despite those ganks top, able to get himself ahead through his team play. The chase is down here. OG Philman just getting kited out and chunked to death by these hyper procs. That Q did a lot of damage. Wait a minute. But he's still getting chased down. Meganar is here. Meanwhile, in the top lane, washing hands. Cocoon just out of range. And Dragon, soul point is here. Do we see them go for it off of reset? Probably not. Guy Fieri kind of owns this bot side of the map right now. This is a crazy game as the Dragon. It has been started by the Nocturne and Guy Fieri. I mean, Ash Arrow coming down, but it is not going to be there in time. That is Ocean Soul going for Fudgy's Feeders. Guy Fieri is almost mega. He wants this fight. Baby Cage is down. He might go for it here. Yeah, he's going for it. He's Hole Breaker. He is there alone, realizing his team is out. Wants to hit that Blast Cone so bad. OG Philman, oh, they do, but it Blast Cones him into the stun. Never mind. Merc Treads has big tenacity. Gets himself out safely. I wonder. Yeah, he maxed out second. Okay. Yeah. And Fudgy's Feeders just confidently walking to this Baron. They know they've outscaled. They know they have the damage, and they got the team fight here. Baron isn't being taken as quickly as one would think. We do have the Elise Smite angle. Going for the poke from Fudgy. From Fleeing Panda, not Fudgy Panda. We go to bot lane, but the Scion Teleport coming in. We want to see what's happening here. Elise repelling in. Going for the Smite. Does get it as we see the objective bounty has been claimed. Viger going to get a two-man stun there with the big damage off the W and the Q. Scion is here dead. Effing TP. Nocturne ulting onto the Ash. He flashes to safety. Fleeing Panda is here alone. Oh my goodness. Death Dance. Keeping Maya alive. But Bung's OnlyFans decided to go for the fight after the steal. And it might be their downfall despite getting the Baron. They saw the Veigar's just not quite doing the damage yet. Because it just threw all that Maya live. Death's Dance heals and damage reduction is still insane, friends. Like, look at that. Oh, clumsy Chocobo getting chunked massively. Hoping the Baron minion's going to delay just a little bit longer. He's got 13 seconds on Young Gun. 10, 9 on OG Philman. Here comes the final push. Gnar is here going to zone him out. Ult him into the Nexus. Gonna kind of kill him off that combo. Gale Force and heal not gonna keep him alive, and the Nexus quickly falls. That is game number one going in favor of Fudgy's Feeders. This is gonna be a crazy series, folks. $51,000 damage, Gnar. Sadly, client is so bugged, I can't even stream it, so. Like, are you not? That is crazy. It's showing up when I click properties. It's just not showing. What if I put you here? Or here? Or here? No. Like, the. Wait, where is my client? I wonder. Where is it? Transform. Ah! It was missing! There's the client. Sadly. Who can tell who is what champion, honestly? We will never know. Is this 51,000 the Gnar, or is it the Jinx? The world may never know, to be honest.
Alrighty, that is going to be it for game number one. I'm going to get me some... Hoagie, let me BM Guy Fieric in peace. And so I'm going to get some water, leave you with some music, and we'll be back with game number two in short order, friends.
It's time to start your own business, to turn your dream into something official. You've got the talent, the know-how, the hustle, and now you've got someone who has your back. LegalZoom has helped launch and support millions of small businesses because we believe everyone deserves a chance to follow their dreams. It's your time, so start an LLC, corporation, or nonprofit with LegalZoom today. LegalZoom.
Spotify, stop giving me ads! I should just use YouTube. What am I doing using Spotify? They have all these playlists on YouTube. I muted myself. Hello and welcome to game number two. Between Fudgy's Feeders and Bung's OnlyFans account, we see the Fleeing Panda... not Fleeing Panda. They're taking away the Fleeing Panda Galio here for game number two and putting it on TTC Rider instead of opting into the Aurelion Soul this time. And we see Hoagie's Twitch coming out. That's a pick he has been playing for a long time, for practicing and prepping for a long time. Leona coming out for Hodor Nation. That is not Hodor Nation. That is Young Gun. And the Clumsy Chocobo getting the Jinx here. That is a takeaway. We probably don't see Veigar. We may see Veigar again. The Singed coming out for OG Philman. That's going to be fun. Is that a diamond one in an average silver match? I don't know who the diamond player is. I know Maye and Washing Hands have both been diamond in the past. But the rest of them are bronze through plat. Right? I think Clumsy Chocobo has been plat before. And Guy Fear going for the Gnar once more. It's going to be a juicy top lane. And we see Fudgy's Feeders banning out, taking away multiple of Fleeing Panda's champions. So we're going to see what he pulls out here for this game number two. Playoffs on the line. This could potentially be the last game of the season for Bung's OnlyFans. And alrighty, the Vi banned away. What do they give Maya? They're going to take the Morgana for Hodor Nation this time around. Could be Galio support, Morgana mid, you never know. We saw Morgana mid last night. What do we see in response from Bung's OnlyFans? Jungler is still available from selecting. As is their mid laner. Gonna go Kha'Zix. Another backline assassin here for Washing Hands. Gonna have to play around this Galio, and he really has two targets right now with the Twitch and the Morgana. Whoopsie. I hope you guys can still see that despite me minimizing it. I bet. Very curious what this final pick here is. And they're gonna go. Oh! The oft-forgotten Fleeing Panda Anivia. Isn't Fleeing Panda one of our many Anivia mains in this league? He's one of the Anivia players, right? As we see Lilia going being covered here from Maye. Lots of derping around. I like Lilia. She's silly. You just gotta run around. Yeah, this is the... If Fleeing Panda is one of our many Anivia players this league has had... Right? Yes? No? Why do I think Fleeing Panda is one of our Anivia players? Where did that thought come from? Either way. Very exciting. And the Lilia getting locked in. Gonna be very fun. Alrighty, gonna be really fun going into this game here, looking at these comps. Bot lane for Bung's OnlyFans, a lot easier execution to a significant degree. It's Leona Jinx, that's bread and butter. You know, get level two, me go in, stun them, chompers, auto with the minigun. Now we go to rockets as you move out farther out of range. Boom.
little bit different for Frenchie's feeders. That bot lane needed that Morgana binding to connect. Now, granted, she can Black Shield the Leona stun, so that is the counterplay. And just kind of walk away nice and happy. But, you know, it could be very interesting to see here. And, of course, the Twitch Flanks could be devastating with the in these big team fights we've been getting here. The Lillia obviously making up for the lack of raw AP damage that Galio brings. A lot of good CC and teamfight potential. Again, another global. If I were to give any notes for DTC Riot for Game 1, it was literally look for stuff out of your lane more. And you might see that here with the Galio. Kind of enable Maye, once the Galio's level 6, enable Maye to invade this Kha'Zix, because Galio's always an ult away. Also, ganking mid hella easy with the Galio. Other side, Sinj versus Gnar. OG Philman wanted to get that split on, get himself ahead, and did not want to be just in the tank, did he want to try and get ahead and get that W? I believe that is what they played game 2 or game 3 of their semis, of their quarterfinals last week. Got them here, had quite a turnaround game with that Sinj to make the comeback. Against Zoo Pals, if it was game 1 or game 2, I want to say game 2. Gonna be a fun one here. You know, it'd be kind of funny is instead of getting like a normal person co-caster, if I got both Nate, like Fudgy and Menbung, the team managers and coaches for these respective squads, to come in here and color cast with me, do a tri-cast with the team managers. That'd be kind of fun. I know Fudgy's listening. Don't know if Menbung's in the chat. That'd be kind of fun though. Young Gun, I see you there. See if you can broach the idea with Menbung. Yeah, it'd be really fun. We do see. I don't know much about the Sinj Gnar match, I'm gonna be very honest. That is way out of my realm of expertise. I can tell you what to do about, if you're Garen, I can tell you what to do in those two. Being the dumb Garen player I am. Kha'Zix Lillia. Gotta be interesting. Lillia's clearly gonna just clear, and be able to put pressure. He's just very Maye champion. He's one of his mains from last season. We saw him play a lot of Lillia, a lot of Udyr. Just clear gank. Kha'Zix not nearly as fast to clear until later on when he gets some items, because he needs that isolation. Mid lane, Galio and Nivea. I mean, very similar to last game. You'd expect the Galio to kind of want to move around and roam after pushing a Nivea in, and then Nivea just going to keep collecting and soaking up that farm. But no Predator option from the Nivea this time. That said, DDC Ryder didn't seem too willing to be the first one to roam last game, so maybe that goes in their favor. So we get into the mid game. Look to the Singe, obviously the Singe and the Gnar. Guy Fieric and OG Philman are just going to want to split push into each other, beat their heads into each other until one of them wins by being the stronger meatcake. I mean, let's be clear, both Jonesy and Eric are beefcakes. You know, they are. That's a man. But that is going to be the story of this game. Honestly, I think a lot of the pressure from last game came through the split pushing top laners. Guy Fieric was the one that was eventually able to kind of scale up and be the one that, despite the craziness of that early game, be the one that really came out on top. And set that pressure in the split push. Yeah, this is interesting, because the Anivia sets up a lot of good zones, but doesn't do really a good job of stopping Gnar from going in. It's going to be kind of the Leona's job. It's got to be kind of up to see if Young Gun's up to the task of keeping this Gnar and Galio off, this T and Lillia. That's a lot of people that are going to be diving them. Maybe they can finally have the damage to play around the zone, this Anivia zone here. Actually, yeah, they have a lot of just kind of damage over time. The long fights definitely go in favor of Bungs Only fans, the Kha'Zix and Jinx for cleanup and resets.
Meanwhile, Pudgy's feeders, it's like, Gnar go in, Lilia set up the sleep, Galio on top of whichever one of them needs the ult. Twitch hits that big fat flank, Morgana hits the ult, like, team fight galore, but with a different set of R buttons than normal. Gonna be very fun. Man, it would be funny if we could get the coaches in here, but I don't think they'd want to jump in here and relay their strategies going into game two. That is correct. Again, reminder, this is game two of this series. Bung's OnlyFans are potentially on their last legs. We did see a... don't want to call it a reverse sweep because it is just a three-game series, but we did see a similar situation happen last night where the game that went down, the team that lost game one came back to win the series. Do we see that happen again here? All right. I see you, Bisonhower, Mofa, Dr. Proctor. Do I know you, or are you just buddies of people that are coming in here? Trying to like put names to tags here. Okay, so. Yeah, this one is a lot harder to dissect in terms of how these comps are going to progress. Just because like last time was, you know, truly just team fight versus pick comp. In a lot of ways. Dive comp versus pick comp. That's not the case here. We have a team... what is kind of a team fight comp up against a damage over time comp. A comp that was kind of set up these zones in these fights. Both these fights... The one thing we can say is these fights are probably going to be... can go pretty long with these two teams. DTC Rider is our dad. Coward. I don't know you. Why am I a coward here in this situation? Okay, get rid of that. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. Oh my gosh. As we go in here, too much. This is why I need Fleeing Panda managing the stream for me here. Alright, 5 point coming out of both squads here. No one wants to try anything risky. Don't want to throw a potential 2-0 and go to bed. Or lose the season off of a silly level 1. Alrighty. Here we go. Bunch of taunting and emoting. I have no idea who you are, Vague Dan. You're just too vague. But I'm sensing some hints of Maokai. Some natural tones. Yeah, because Leona just kind of goes in and it's like, mind game, who do you black shield? Kha'Zix going leashless, so that and without any invade, there's no telling where Kha'Zix started. But we do see both junglers are going to be meeting up in this top lane, so that 2v2 is... I mean, they could gank mid, but I think the way these two teams like to play, I think it's a safe bet to say they're going to go top lane. Though it would be interesting to see if Mae plays off of the strength of the Galio assist in the mid lane. Oh. Once again, good push into the level 2, coming in here out of Young Gun and Clumsy Chocobo. This Bung's OnlyFans bot lane playing smartly. We do see Leona's positioning not quite aggressively enough to punish on the level 2. Maybe a bit of a miscommunication. Young Gun just kind of standing back. Maybe pushed in too far to really punish that level 2. We see the Kha'Zix, Mae going for a 5 camp clear. Most likely. Sorry, Mae going for the 6 camp. OG Film, I'm flipping Guy Fieri. While washing hands is going for the 5 camp clear. Ooh, these stuns, these skill shots. OG Philman trying to ghost to safety, but he almost certainly dies here. Solo Bolo in the top lane for Guy Fieri. So, really crazy early game here. Well, not crazy, really craziness in the top lane as both these top laners just love beating their faces into each other. As OG Philman teleporting top, ready for some more binding. Gonna connect onto the Leona in the bot lane. And we see now the Kha'Zix finishing his clear before the Lily with that 315. There's the grounded. OG Philman gets another grounded off the hop from Guy Fieri. Could be being baited into a skirmish with Maye. We see Washing Hands is looking at this mid lane. Ping's coming out. DTC Ryder playing very safe. Fleeing Panda maybe showing his hand just a little bit too much there. DTC Ryder's spidey sense is tingling. Ooh. All right, Meganar coming out here as we see Maya is the top lane. Does flip him to avoid the stun. Does OG Philman stay alive long enough for his jungler to get here? Gets hit by the bowling ball from Maya. Red buff has been proc'd. Washing Hand jumps in, tries to get the isolation on Guy Fieri. Triumph is keeping him alive. No red buff onto Washing Hands, but he does get the kill for OG Philman. Flash is available for Washing Hands. Tries to get the isolation. Tries to win the 1v1, but dies to the two different dots from the red buff. And that is going to be that. Oh, stun does hit onto Hodor Nation. Clumsy Chocobo gets one auto. No ignite has gone down. The proc from the W from Young Gun getting the kill. Tries to get the stun. Super Hoagie flashing out to safety. Looks for another one. Root does not connect. And that is going to be the support. Young Gun getting that kill in the bot lane again. Alrighty. Maya going to be trying to make a play here in the mid lane. Galio has great gank set up. 1E bowling ball. Ooh, misspaces it. It hits the wall and kind of gives up the whole jig as we see. Probably a fight going to happen here. Washing Hands knows Maya is coming. Has the isolation. Gets early damage onto him. Flash and jump are available. Waiting out. Oh, gets his jump interrupted. He was waiting out the Justice Punch from DTC Ryder. Now using his invisible slow there. Oh, wow. Smartly knowing there was a Q coming from the Maya there. Something to keep in mind. Washing Hands is a Lilia player. That is his main. Almost always permaband. Very frequently permaband against him. So he knows what to expect from that champ. Was expecting that Q. So some kills traded back in and forth between these two teams. Maye looking at top lane. OG Philman likes to play up, likes to trade. Could be baited by the ward. He does has no vision. That river is darkness. Now sees that he's got some company up here. Thankfully, a blast plant is there to save the day. He's going to have to be careful. He won't be so lucky maybe next time. Singe, of course, is a very slippery character, but it's not that slippery. We need more items to four our points. Sadly, I have no control over that. I am just a humble caster streamer. I can't change titles. I can't put up the money. I can't put up the casino for gambling for points. Oh, Hodor Nation pushed out very far bot. Used the Black Shield to get himself to safety. Young Gun gets the root. Doesn't get the stun there. Black Shield keeping Hodor Nation alive as OG Philman getting punished in the top lane. That sleep lasted no time. Does he get extra tenacity from that ult? That was insane. Or did they proc it? Proc the sleep really early. That was crazy. Why wasn't he asleep for that long? That's insane. But good on OG Philman. Once again, escaping being punished for pushing up so far. Going for the flip onto Guy Fieri. Gets the flip. Doesn't get the stun that time. They woke him up. Okay, I didn't quite see that. Oh, man. Super close. All right. Meanwhile, let's look at the mid lane. We see Fleeing Panda up 11 farm against DTC Riders Galio. Galio is 6 now. I would love... And he has that Predator. He could have roamed already with the Predator, but I would love to see him. He's disappearing. Be like, hey, getting those pings. Galio's missing. Care, we don't know where Galio is. However, that's what you would expect. But this ward is so smart. He saw Galio went bot. There should be Fleeing Panda should be screaming in the mic right now. Galio looking bot. He's level 6. You could see this right now in the respect that Clumsy Chocobo. I mean, he's 2v1, but like the respect that they're showing in the bot lane. They know Galio is bot side. That ward does so much. Very smart to catch when the Galio wants to do just that. Sneak away and give that hidden pressure. Oop, move my mouse, sorry. All right, Young Gun back in this lane. Jinx and the Twitch. Sorry, no, only Twitch. Super Hoagie is level 6. OG Philman, Guy Fieric, again, continue to be the story of this game, constantly trading with each other. We know how much Direct-to-Camera loves top lane. That lead is ballooning in mid lane. Fleeing Panda up 20 CS. Super Hoagie is black shielded. They might look for some action there. Decide against it. Galio ult is in range of Lilia, we see being pinged. Oop. Put that there. Dragon is going to be up in 2 minutes. There goes the fight here. Both junglers are top lane. Guy Fieric is going to be the one punished this time. He jumps in, gets the ult, flashes to safety, but will be killed by the poison of OG Philman. Thought he had the time. Knew Maya was up there, but didn't expect washing hands. Man, and we talked before this series. This series is going to be crazy with these brawls between the junglers and the tops, and it has not disappointed. Two early games in a row here. But I think the story of this game may come down to the CS lead in the mid lane. The Anivia has been ganked once, but not feeling too much pressure here. Able to farm freely, and DDC Ryder hasn't looked to make a play with these Predator boots. OG Philman finding himself bowling balled, put to sleep. Does get the bonk from the Lilia. Avoids the Q! Barely with this movement speed! Galio comes through, but it is not in time. Washing Hands may look for some more here, or may bite off more than he can chew. Jinx, Rocket, coming in. No, that's not going to hit. Dang, that would have been crazy. I don't think it would have killed the Galio, but it would have been crazy. Oop, Leona looking to go in. Hoder Nation starting this fight with an ultimate. Flash away by Clumsy Chocobo. Young Gun does not have... Oh, he hits 6 and gets the ult. Stuns up Super Hoagie for a little bit longer, but Clumsy Chocobo is too low. Gets the stun. Super Hoagie now just going to opt for the consolation prize of getting Super Hoagie. Ah, names are hard. Binding connects. Super Hoagie gets the consolation prize of killing Young Gun 18, and the emotes have come out. OG Philman. And... Ooh, gets the ult out of Guy Fieric. Knows he doesn't have vision there. I'm expecting Washing Hands to come out of a bush. Instead, Washing Hands sees a low Twitch. He's just walking in. They know he's there. It's going to come down to a binding. There's the black shield stopping the slow. Binding does connect, but it is... Oh, that you got to feel bad. He's trying to buy time for Maya to get there, but it is not enough. Double kill. Man, these teams like to play greedy. Zero respect for the jungler. My goodness. Bug. Alrighty. Right? Oh, looks like that Zhonya's was not intended. You hate to see it. We do not have access to Chrono Break. Though, I do know Greg is around. Greg's around. He might be able to chrono break this for us. He works for Riot, right? Mid lane, 20 CS lead maintained. We do see a 20 CS lead in the bot lane as well. Kind of mitigating the damage from the kills Super Hoagie has. Oh, this is the this is the real Maya special. Somehow finding himself in the enemy team's jungle, surrounded by enemies, and somehow getting out. Alrighty, battle lines are drawn. Young Gun goes into Super Hoagie, gets the black shield out early. Binding gonna connect, but they are jumping in. Ultimate's coming out from Maya and Hodor Nation. It is not enough. The AoE comes clean here. DTC Ryder, Justice punching in, sees his angle, but the Anivia has egg, root, and stun. DTC Ryder may try to get Young Gun, but it is not enough. That is a one mid-river skirmish here for Bung's Only fans. Stale meme. Nah. Memes never get stale, they just get more annoying. So you're not gonna drink like something really bitter and say, yeah, that's stale. Alrighty. This game looking really close, though. We had the same thing happen last game. Really back and forth. In fact, we saw a 2K gold lead at this exact time last game for Bungs Only fans. And, you know, the Gnar got ahead, was able to split push. The Nocturne was able to dive in onto the back line. The dive options aren't so easy this time. There is no Nocturne to just kind of catch people out whenever Maye wills it. No Jinx Assurance. See, however, they can try to bring things home. Next steps here for... Gank coming in top. Yeah, that should be a dead guy. Fieric is going to go Mega pretty soon. Nope, not in time. Excuse me. Maya going to try and sneak a Scuttle Crab here before Wash Hands inevitably goes for this Rift. But I was going to say, what Bungs Only fans probably want to do here, they know... Oh, man, that is a lot of damage. DDC Rider going in, going to trade with the Anivia as Washing Hands gets the kill on to Maye. 5-3-4 on this Kha'Zix. 5 kills deep. And we are more than a kill a minute once again. And, you know, the point I keep trying to make is keeps getting proven wrong by Bungs Only fans. What I would like to see them do is just kind of... They know they're in the lead. They know they've got the setup here and the team fight to really try and win out fights around objectives. So just... Play it slow, scale up, farm. Ooh, good flash, Root, and the Gale Force in. Coming in here from Young Gun and Clumsy Chocobo. Ult going out to Super Hoagie, who is now gets exhausted and chased down by this Jinx Leona combo. That is double kill in the bot lane for Bungs Only fans. Killing spree, too. Oh. Kha'Zix pinging, he's coming mid. DTC Rider getting pushed out by Fleeing Panda. Oh, spicy teleport. Those teleports are very unleashed now as the ward teleport coming in from Guy Fieric. There are two shutdowns in this bot lane, and these shutdowns are... Chompers may save the day here. Galio coming through, trying to get the Jinx. There we go. Shutdown into Gnar and to DTC Rider there. Good use of the now recently unleashed teleport to go to that ward. And we see these bot lanes... this is really just over... Aggression, greed against greed here. Punishing the overextensions on repeat by these junglers for their laners here. And again, we get the Rift Herald. They move super quickly. Oh, Washing Hands. Gonna get the sleep. But Maye gets flipped. Chunks very low. The sleep proccing just in time. But Washing Hands deleting him. We see Super Hoagie just free firing in the middle of four enemy team members. Tries to get the expunge. But is too slow. And they give up on the chase. I believe that is 2-1 and the Rift Herald. Oh, Jinx Rocket. Whoo! And the objective bounty coming in hot bot. Leona ult. Trying to finish. They really want Super Hoagie. Oh, man. Just fights left and right for these two teams. So, what I was liking is what I was trying to say. Bungs Only fans kind of just play it slow. They got the lead. Find their picks. Now, we're just going to keep fighting. Teams like to bang their heads into each other and fight constantly. Alright, Dragon is up in a minute. Which team's going to get the first move here? Young Gun wants to set up that vision, but Maye is here first. Going to go for the Scuttle Crab. Young Gun gets hit by the bowling ball, is slowed. Actually going to look to turn onto Maye. Gets the root, gets the stun. Clumsy Chocobo is there for the follow-up. Well, Maye walking away from the Chompers. No Leona ultimate available. Young Gun may find himself on the receiving end of this. We see Washing Hands has found TTC Rider on the side, but Super Hoagie is there to save him. Washing Hands has to burn his ultimate for safety to get himself out safely, and he does. So this is going to be a huge Dragon fight here. Kha'Zix does not have ultimate. Maye and Guy Fieric ults are going to be up soon here, and this drags in 35 seconds. So the only ult that will not be available is that Kha'Zix one. Hodor Nation might be the next second support we see caught out today, warding around. Washing Hands, he was going to flash out, no point chasing him. But two times now we see the support trying to go for this vision alone, and both times punished by the jungler. Alright, here we go. DTC Rider has no teleport. Starting to move down bot. Use that ult to get into the scrap. He's half health from the minion wave. Bung's OnlyFans have the first move here. They have the vision control, but they haven't cleared all the wards. This is going to be a pick here onto Guy Fieric, or at least attempted. He's almost Meganar, trying to run away, going to jump away from Young Gun, going to look for the root. In fact, just drops the ult, gets the slow. Oh, backs away. Maybe a miscommunication. Washing hands, tanking a couple tower shots. Fleeing Panda getting hit and half health by Maye. And now we see that their entire team of Fungi's feeders have made their way into this while Washing Hands and Fleeing Panda, like the end, all of Bung's OnlyFans are chunked. They want this dragon. They're going to maybe start it. No, Binding going to connect onto Young Gun. And here comes the ult. Here comes the AoE. OG Phil, man. DTC Rider's the first one to go down, however, somewhere on the side. Super Hoagie trying to free fire. And indeed, he does get a kill himself. But Washing Hands turns it. And the Gale Force Slash from Clumsy Chocobo going to finish off that fight. And that's what we talked about, the zone control from Bung's OnlyFans account really winning that fight for them. They did get womboed. Bung's OnlyFans, Fudgy's Feeders wanted to wombo them there, but they didn't quite get the damage in time. I think DTC Rider was killed before his ult was able to fully finish. Washing Hands really deleting him on the side here, but the their entirety of Fleeing Panda's job and OG Philman's job is to get them low enough for the Jinx and the Kha'Zix to get these resets. And that happened, that fight, now into a 5k gold lead on Soul Point with Cloudrake. And this is a team that does benefit from Cloudrake, few though they are, because Kha'Zix with his ult with extra movement speed, nuts. Singe with the movement speed from his ult, nuts. Leona with movement speed, gonna ult walk in at you that extra faster, really strong. And the subtle unsung one with a Cloudrake soul, Anivia gets that extra movement speed while her ult is down. So this is a pretty good squad to have the movement speed buff. It's not going to be as good as, like, you know, Ocean Soul or something. Like, don't get me wrong. But they're going to have big benefits to chase him down here. Now, if I am on the side of Fudgy's Feeders, I'm thinking, okay, we know OG Philmon's going to split. We may be able to catch him there. We know Young Gun likes to go warding missions alone. We almost caught him out before. And also, we chunked him super hard. So maybe a little bit more poke from Maye. Hodor Nation did get caught to start that fight, sitting in that bush alone. If they get some poke in and fight on their own terms instead of getting kind of force fought onto, they can easily turn this game around at objective with, like, Baron bonking them too. As it stands, it looks like we may be going into a game 3 here, though. It's PMALCS. Nothing is guaranteed. Oh, Washing Hands. They know they have the time to get this red buff Maye forced out of his jungle. Hodor Nation wants to try and zoink it. We see OG Philman gets the flash out of Guy Fieric, now runs away. We see Young Gun going in onto Hodor Nation. Here comes another fight by Hodor Nation getting caught out. Young Gun going in onto Super Hoagie, gets the ult, gets the stun onto the bot lane. They both get out to safety. DTC Rider flashing to safety. As we see Maye getting dove under tower by Washing Hands. Guy Fieric on the side. This fight is so split. Fleeing Panda looking for an angle to TP. Maybe doesn't need to. Walking in. Young Gun E goes wide, but does get the stun onto Super Hoagie. Gets flipped into by OG Philman. Young Gun sacrifice is worth it. This Gnar is almost Mega. We see OG Philman running to safety. Meganar coming in over the wall. The ult does not connect. Fleeing Panda is here. He can set up the zone. We see the choppers coming in, and both of those two players gonna get caught up in that zone. Fleeing Panda onto killing spree, gonna get the stun onto Guy Fieric. DTC Rider caught by Washing Hands off the side. Guy Fieric having to get himself to safety. It is a 2-for-3 right now. However, we see Singe is the one that is backed, has teleport available. Maye throwing the bowling ball, does not connect. No Baron to be taken, but that is a solid team fight win in favor of Bung's OnlyFans, and caught off once again, starting off by catching out Hodor Nation. Washing Hands, bop! Coming in on the flank to finish the cleanup. And now we're going to be looking into a Baron. Jungler is dead. We have a Liandry's. We have a Demonic Embrace. We have a Kha'Zix isolation damage. Our Jinx is on the way. We are chilling. This Baron already at half health. It is very dead Baron. Oh, Washing Hands doesn't even care for the smite fight there. No, he doesn't even have smite. Alrighty, this game, I mean, wow, it's only 22 minutes in. Holy crap. This game's been crazy as we come up on the soul point for Cloud Soul here. Scraps back and forth. The story of this game being this jungle match of Kha'Zix's popping off. Getting these clean ups in these team fights. Oh, they're going to try and catch DTC Ryder here. They don't know Maye's there. Maye's going to get out to safety. I've seen this before. Maye gets his teammate in trouble once again. But, I mean, at this point, they got to kind of go for those desperation plays. See the angle to catch someone with a shutdown out in a side lane. You got to look for it because right now you're down 8,000 gold. That is how you're going to get yourself back into it. Staying here under tier tower. Tier 2 tower is a bait. It's a trap. Never defend tier 2 tower. Hodor Nation almost learned that lesson and they almost lost. Had another fight get started by a catch out onto Hodor Nation. Alrighty, and that is the Cloud Soul Young Gun. Shooting his shot, fleeing Panda. That is a fast bird. He came zooming in. What the heck? Just running through with the Cloud Soul and with that. I wonder if he had movement speed from his ult being up a little bit earlier ago. Washing hands. He's just going in. Going into Hoagie. Doesn't care. Unstoppable. Maye. Yeah, no, he's dead. All right, we see that movement speed from the Anivia taking to effect here. When these ults drop, look at how fast she goes around. That is super good. Anivia, main weakness, of course, being that lack of maneuverability. But with the Cloud Soul, that really changes the game. Guy Fieri, gonna see an angle, gets stunned by Young Gun on the engage, followed up CC, and is chased down. Fleeing Panda using that moving speed to get away from the Morgana binding. And the desperation plays are just not working. I'm not saying they're bad. They're good to go for. You got to do something. Try and get something here when you're this far behind. Collect the shutdown gold. It's just unfortunate. None of them are quite panning out the way they want as we see potentially the final siege. Maya gets the flash ult in. He does have Zhonya. He's going to get himself to safety. The sleep getting on multiple members. OG Philman is down. Young Gun is down. And the rest of their team walks away. That's the desperation play they needed. What an engage from Maya on this Lilia. And the gold lead's now 9,000. They reduced it by about 1,000 there. How many shutdowns did they get? Oh, I can't pull up chat. It doesn't... Sad. They got 400 gold shutdown onto Twitch. That's good. Lilia did get a 500 gold shutdown on Watching Hands before that. That's decent gold. It's a start. That said, the item differential here. This Jinx is going to back. How much gold does she have in the bank? What the heck? What just happened? I broke. Okay, we're good. There we go. So we can see that Jinx is still only at 2.5 items. Oh, no, there's the third. I was like, where's the third item? There's the third item. Jinx at 3 items. Twitch, not quite there yet. We see he's going, I think that's a Titanic Hydra Twitch. I'm not familiar with Twitch these days, so I'm assuming that's the build. Kha'Zix with 4 items, however. Dead boy. But Washing Hands maybe dead himself. Oh, my goodness. He immediately chunks. Maya almost gets the kill there. Gets resurrected. And this is a dead. Oh! All the CC misses. He gets out in time. No, Guy Fieri is going to collect that shutdown. Fleeing Panda is here. Clumsy Chocobo is here. They don't have Washing Hands. He, of course, is dead. OG Philman trying to push down this inhibitor. It's Sis Pink's coming out for Fudgy's feeders. Meanwhile, the push in the mid lane. This is what you want to see here. Get that pressure from both mid and bot. Oh, my gosh. The red buff is just chunking out DTC Ryder here. Guy Fieri can try and get himself some Meganar. He has a red buff himself. The whole squad is here. Kha'Zix is still dead. as this game goes on, those death timers get longer and longer. These picks are what they need. Do we have another miracle engage out of Maya? Zanya's is up once more. Baron coming up in 28 seconds. This is going to be a big determining fight here. And something to keep in mind, much like the Elise won, win smites last game, Kha'Zix definitely wins smites in this game. DDC Rider gets chunked by minions a lot. He just tanks the minions when he's trying to clear a wave. Unless that's from... Oh, good flash. That is a dead deer. As OG Philman now takes the 1v1 against Guy Fieric and runs away from the Mega Gnar. But that Maya getting caught there trying to set up for this Baron steal or Baron fight potentially. Young Gun heads up flash stun. And that is a Baron. You think that this would be the end of the game here unless we have another miracle team fight, miracle skirmish, some pick here. Gonna go with the wave top. That's where it's at. OG Philman gonna go bot. They're gonna want to sync up these pushes. But, I mean, right now it's kind of time to just pull out the wallet and smack them in the face with it. Play together and show that you have more items in the bank. Instead, opting to play it slow, play it safe. They have supers coming in mid. Play with those baroned up minions. Wait for OG Philman to get the push in bot. They don't want to throw it potentially, because remember, if they lose this game, that's it. Season done. Playoffs over for them. Guy Fieric, Meganar's almost up. This is a window. They're all grouped as five. Fudgy's Feeders, Chomper's going to dissuade any further action. And Hodor Nation caught out again on the side. 4v4 here. Meganar ulting him into the squad, but the Leona ult onto the backline. Maya trying to run rampant onto the backline does do a lot of damage. 2v1. Hoagie dies to the Kha'Zix on the other side. Both junglers just beast moding it in out of the back line. However, we see that the money is just too much, too many items as OG Philman finishes off his lane opponents. And that is an ace and almost certainly the game here with the Baron and the Jinx. Let's get a replay of that before we finish up here as we see. Because we saw Maya going in on the back line of Fudgy's Bugs Only fans, but watch this here. Young Gun goes in. Guy Fieric tries to flash out, peel for them, and here comes Washing Hands. Bink, bam, bong. So far ahead, doesn't even need isolation damage. Gets the double kill, dies to Guy Fieric, but man. All right, jumping back here. Yep, they get the push, end the game. GG's, we're going to game number three, folks. Who doesn't love some late night league? Okay, who doesn't love watching some late night league? I mean, man, what a crazy game. Washing Hands popping off on this Kha'Zix. Do we see a ban on it next game? Who knows? Because Viegor Graves, there's a lot of options, a lot of jungle picks that could be taken here. But until then, I am going to get some, take a quick respite from this microphone, and I'll see you as we get in for game number three, friends. We'll be right back.
And we are back. Game number three, friends. This is it for all the marbles to play in the finals or have your dreams of a champion just kind of washed away. So here we go. We see Bungs Only Fans taking the Nocturne away this time. So see what comp they're trying to build here. And a Tauric in response for Hodor Nation here to kind of counteract the die. Fudgy's Feeders chose blue side for this game. Yeah, and there's the Tauric to immediately counter the dive from the Nocturne Galio combo. See what they pick up next here. Bans, first rotation have stayed relatively the same, except this time Bungs Only Fans did not want to give away that Gnar. Olaf is an option on the table for Fudgy's Feeders. And with a Tauric, Olaf Tauric is very spooky. Nope, they're going to give DTC Rider his main. Ride or die on this Aurelion Soul here. It is game three in playoffs. Give the man his main. And this is going to be pretty interesting because both of these champions are going to roam. And Bungs Only Fan, the Galio, obviously like one of Fleeing Panda's best champions. We showed how proficient he was at that Anivia last game on his comfort. And OG Philman grabbing the Singed once more. A lot of comfort here for mid and top. All right, what are the next bans coming up? What picks do you want to take? What picks do you want to get about not take? They take the Shen away from Fudgy's Feeders, from Guy Fieric. He likes that Shen, and he's going to, again, prevent more dive. More dive prevention. They're going to take away Clumsy Chocobo's Ash. Ooh, I don't want to say it yet because I don't want to spoil things. Kha'Zix, that was the other one I was thinking. Like, get the Kha'Zix away. Miami want to take down Retribution. Yep, I was wondering if they're going to ban the Ahri because Clumsy Chocobo has played. Ahri bought this split. Be a pick to pull out now. I wonder if we maybe see a Victor. Doubt it. I mean, Clumsy Chocobo plays Samira. Samira is up. Might not be what they want. More dive and more kind of just burst into that. They're going to get the Leona. So waiting on ADC here. I wonder what they have up their sleeve on Bungs Only Fans account. You got to know Fudgy's Feeders got to be thinking the same thing. Sion putting Guy Fieric on the boy, though I personally would like to see the Ornn, but I don't know how Ornn Singed goes. So Guy Fieric opting into the Sion this time himself. Big Beefcake, never die. What do we see? Lilia's up. Olaf is up. Again, I think this is a nutty time for Olaf. With the Tauric. Like, maybe not fit the best against them, but, like, you can make Julio's day. Clumsy Chocobo, sorry, his day. Very sad with an Olaf and a Tauric on top of you. My gosh. Ooh, dear. Olaf, but tankier. Udyr having a slight resurgence right now. And this is one of Maie's big champs from last season. He is an Udyr player through and through. It fits him very well, very slippery, very aggressive. And that is going to be his ride or die pick here in game number three of semis for our mini split of winter 2022. Sivir is the pick for Clumsy Chocobo. So lots of run at you and dive make Jinx not have a good time. Does Hodor Nation have it in him with this Tauric? We will see. We get draft is finished. The coaches are going to say, team managers are going to say their last words to their teams before. Surprise, joining us for the TriCast. I'm getting both coaches, team managers in this for a TriCast for game number three. There is no fear of them, you know, giving up any strats or anything. Going into a game three. Whoops. I need to go there.
Oh, man. Very exciting. I'll give my initial thoughts here, looking at these comps. We have a lot of dive on Bung's OnlyFans with the Galio, the Nocturne, the Leona, and the Sivir. Like, that's run at them, go hard. With the Singe, too. Yeah, we're going in and running at you. Vudgie's Feeders, I mean, the moment they saw the Nocturne Galio, immediately countered with the Tauric. And the Aurelion Souls ultimate does have disengage potential as well. So we have a lot of good disengage from Fudgy's Feeders. The engage from the Scion and the Udyr is just going to run havoc. That said, Udyr may have a bit of a hard time walking into, you know, Galio, Singed, or Sivir and do what he wants to do. He's going to get spell shielded, and then he's going to have to wait to stun her again. So it's going to come down to this clear and this early pressure for Udyr, for Baye. Go through one last pick ban here. Both semifinal series, pretty bangers. I mean, I know the games last night were pretty quick, but it's a fun series. And then this one, obviously, two back and forth games already. Hopefully another crazy one to finish us off here. Both these teams love to scrap. Oh, man. Udyr's obviously always in a matchup in Nocturne. One of the big things you want to ask yourself is how you can affect the map before the Nocturne is level 6. Galio, I might not be surprised to see a Nocturne gank mid. I think Galio's gank setup is super strong and kind of able to mitigate Nocturne's weaknesses pre-6 as a ganker. So there's a chance for that. I can see them trying to opt into a 2v2. I think their 2v2 even... No, Udyr kind of is pretty strong. So maybe not. Yeah, no. No, if it was another jungler, but Udyr... That Phoenix is just going to hurt Phoenix stance. Man, I mean, top lane is just going to be another battle, just bonking at each other for an entire game. What these two guys love to do. OG Philman, Guy Fieri providing some exciting action. We'll see if, and one of the things I want to point out about bot lane, both games, Young Gun and Clumsy Chocobo, have been able to grab their level 2 advantage both games. Like, they're able to get to level 2 first. We saw a little bit of a desync, kind of maybe push too hard for it in game 2, so they weren't able to capitalize. Like, Young Gun didn't look aggressively for that EQ as soon as they hit it. Maybe we'll see that happen this time. Also, might see some level 1 shenanigans. Level 1 from Fudgy's Feeder is very strong. Even if you don't go bear stance to the Udyr, tiger stance does a lot of bleed damage over time. And Tauric stun is really, really strong in level 1. The Aesol gets effectively two abilities with his stun to follow up and his passive. That said, level 1 for Bugs Only fans, also pretty crazy. Actually, maybe even way better. AoE taunt. Or the AoE Q from the Galio. We have Nocturne Q. And Leona Stun and Sivir Q. That's a lot of AoE damage you have to avoid if you're Fudgy's Feeders. It's going to be hard to say. I can't really make a prediction here. Because it's going to come down to how the... Because I think both teams' draft play to their strengths and what they want to do here. I think Fudgy's Feeders' draft counters what Bung's OnlyFans wants to do. Purely off the just because, like, they have a lot of disengage. That said, Bung's OnlyFans has a lot of ways of ignoring your disengage. Two spell shields, a Galio ult to save you when you dive, and Singe to slipperiness, and a Sivir, a lot of movement speed. So it's gonna really come down to execution and how these skirmishes are gonna go. Both teams have bruiser people that can do damage. A little bit more damage on Bung's OnlyFans.
Oh. Yo, that blue team draft sucks.
Yo, alrighty. Alright, so introduce yourself so we can have we have people who don't watch the league usually. So introduce yourself and tell us what team you manage coach for, and then I have a question for you before we get into this game here.
Alright, go for it, team.
Hold on. Oh man, this is good.
So
I'm Fudgy. Captain of Fudgy's Feeders, or TM Fudgy's Feeders. I'm on the blue side draft this game.
And the other voice in our head?
The other voice in your head is Sean Minbung, and I am the TM/coach of Bung's OnlyFans.
Yeah. So here's my question for you. I want, before we go for the meme analysis, which I'm
Got
here
it.
For, the real thoughts from each of you, what you think the other comp strengths are and their win goals are. WinCon is here, like what they want to achieve. So like Menbung, what is Fudgy's Feeders going to try and do here, and vice versa?
Okay, well, they have Jinx, who seems to be the prior pick of the series, right? So they got that. They have a really, really strong front to back, like in terms of like their front line is beefier than the red side with Sion. And Sion's going to be almost unkillable, depending on like how Sivir builds, right? It's going to be really, really tough. And Udyr is not necessarily, in my opinion, 1v9, but he is very, very good in this draft, where he's going to be very annoying, especially if Ferrix stuns can go around. So. Yeah.
Not 1v9, but he is 1v5 status.
He's probably like at least 1v6 for sure. Yeah.
All right.
Fudgy, your thoughts on, again, this is the no meme analysis. We'll get to memes in a little bit.
Okay. It's a 2-damage dive comp with Nocturne Sivir as the main damage. Rest of the map has no damage, so all I have to worry about is exhausting Nocturne and diving Sivir, so that's just Udyr's job. Otherwise, you can just peel off everybody with Taric, Aurelion, Soul on my end. So, yeah, Nocturne Galio, that's like the strongest combo on Bofa's comp, so it's just about watching for the Nocturne, slamming the exhaust, and running away. I mean, as soon as Nocturne goes in, if my team hits the Taric ulti, I think it's good. Just a matter of how these fights, you know.
But like, if they get ahead, that dive is going to be potentially really difficult to deal with, as we saw in game one from Fudgy's Feeders.
Right. So, these drafts were really interesting, I think.
Yeah. Okay.
Games.
Now, tell me how your team wins. You can get Mimi here.
1v9.
we've described it's 1v6, man.
No, it's 1v9.
I mean, hey. Hodor's a good-natured guy. It may be a 1v6, man. I saw Hodor's positioning right. last game.
Can you
I'll be streaming in Discord. I'm streaming in Discord.
You.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Oh, okay. Perfect.
Yeah, so the only other thing I would say is the way my team wins is that they have a 1-damage comp with a really, really annoying guy in a bear suit. So as long as Jinx is not allowed to play the game, we are confident that the rest of the guys will turn around and be like, well, okay, run at them, Udyr. And he'll be like, I am! And that'll be it.
That's game. GG. I am running at them! And it's like...
Yeah. Udyr runs, but we run faster.
How do you guys like to fight? Are you guys kiting with that comp? Are you guys kiting with Nocturne and Galio?
So the thing is, it's like you actually have two forms in this. So like Nocturne Galio is like traditionally a engage, burst, kill one person, and then you win the numbers advantage fight, right? As you can see, we have Young Gun going Aftershock and Clumsy Chocobo not doing the lethality or even like the airy thought style via like total landscaping.
Ooh, Young Gun. Bailed out by the 5-point.
I don't know if going specifically fleet is best, but it's better than I think the poke lane and into the.
Yeah, Maya so like. Okay, there it is.
Maya's getting that big ward out. Oh no.
Okay, first blood. You're done.
Yo, first ward.
Oh!
Okay.
Okay. Better mechanics on my team.
True. Right,
okay.
really quick.
Sivir.
So
yeah, my team can't see that. They have chat off. I told them.
Maya can see it.
Yeah.
He's lying.
Maya's lying.
Yeah.
So something I do want to point out here is like that to kind of go off of the point that Bung has. It's kind of like how people see Amumu as very one dimensional. He's like he go in press R, but no one understands that Amumu can also just say I'm not going to go in. I'm just going to sit here and be an AoE you can't go into. And so that's kind of what it seems like the concept here may be.
So then, and then the way that works, just to finish the point off, is like, so then Galio is back there peeling with Leona. And then you have Singed and Nocturne as the divers. And Singed is annoying as fuck. And you have no point-and-click lockdown except for Udyr. So if Udyr's on Singed, we win. By the way, you need to change scenes.
Oh, no! Ah! There we go. Thank you.
Hey, chat, press 1 if you didn't show the entire game last game.
I showed the entire game last game. I will rewind a little bit here. I'm going to rewind a little bit here because the power of this here. I am so, so sorry.
I missed the ward. Okay, we got to see the ward.
Oh, yeah, we got to see the skin. And then can we turn the off so we don't see it? And the stuff on.
Yep, there we go.
Yeah. Oh, they can't auto attack fast enough.
Fred, I've been told to tell you to fix stream. I don't know what that means.
It is. It is here. It is here. Yes.
I see Gooks goes poison the good in news, my DMs.
Yep. Yeah, the good news is that I can imagine more interactive. The good news is because we are just streaming in Discord, those goofs are easily fixed with a quick rewind, especially this early in the game.
Wait, dude, we didn't even talk about the Sion. What do you guys do about that?
So the difference with Sion is like, while he can, he will do the same job that either OG Failman's probably going to do for my team. But I think the difference is your comp is extremely mono damage. Like,
I don't know, Devin
no
puts
offense.
Up damage, bro.
Okay, I'll be honest. For a guy who plays a lot of Aurelion Sol, I was kind of underwhelmed by the amount of mastery points that he has.
Oh, he's like a brand new league player.
Oh, well, then that's cool.
Yeah, he's a Dota player.
Also,
yeah.
people said, oh, he's an Aurelion Sol one trick. He played it one time in Combines. And then he's like, oh, I guess I'm a one trick now.
Well, I mean,
well, so what I would
first,
like to see.
If it's the first game you play and you've only been playing the game for 3 weeks, yeah, for sure. You're
so,
a one
like, something, I, something I've noticed in the last game that will be very interesting in game one, DTC Ryder doesn't use his Comet of Legend to move around a lot. Like, he plays lane well, but he doesn't find a way to impact the other lanes. In the laning phase.
The
obviously, once we're out of lane, like. He played insane.
Wait, hold on. Fudgy, can you repeat that?
What? I said Eric walking back into the poison 3 times during that trade. Very interesting.
Yeah, how do we deal with the Sion? We don't. We let Sion deal with himself. All right.
Yeah, apparently.
Okay, so I'm not familiar with... So this top lane matchup, we're just bonking at each other. Yep, that's Galio into anyone. It's like, all right, I got my passive auto. Me go in and chunk you for that much damage. Ooh, clumsy Chocobo Virilio here, going to get the flash out of Super Hoagie and the heal. Young Gun really threatened the needle. Wait, no, that's not a skill shot that gets blocked by minions, but Young Gun really finding Jinx there. Guy Fieric and OG Philman both love fighting. They love fighting so much.
Yeah. I think they got the top end of that trade this time, but their pot's being burned now by Singed, so.
Yeah,
Young Gun really loving this bush. Hodor Nature trying to get the flash done here. Maya is in the bot lane. We see in the mid lane, DTC Ryder getting very low as the fight continues. Bot stun coming in from Young Gun. Super Hoagie getting chased out. Exhaust is down on clumsy Chocobo. Young Gun probably the next target. Flashes out to safety. Hodor Nation looking for a stun. Doesn't get it, but also jukes out the
roof.
Stop canceling
your
auto! Ona and the boomerang blade coming out from clumsy Chocobo as Menbung has an aneurysm on stream. I see the blood vessels popping on his camera as someone call the ambulance for him.
I'll be honest, I had to pull out a fucking tequila for last game. I knew it was going to give me a heart attack.
My team did some interesting stuff right there by not immediately focusing the Leona, who is clearly out of position, and instead just letting her get away and flash. So it's pretty cool. Pretty cool.
Yeah, so this honestly, I will say that this is...
Here we go, the 2v2. Instead, it's more of a 1v3 as Washing Hands. Oh, Fear gets there in time. Fleeing Panda is here. DTC Ryder is here. It is a 3v3 right now.
Wait.
But half health fleeing. Oh, it's one knock. Just punch, two-man taunt as the AoE is coming through here. Washing Hands going to get that auto passive, doing so much damage and healing him up so much. It is going to be 3-for-nothing here in this river fight. Oh, Guy Fieric trying to get the autos. They get the runaway and the flip from OG Fieldman. Fleeing Panda almost dying to a couple more autos, but knowing...
He killed Sion twice.
That is really rough there. It looked like an easy dub. Washing Hands getting caught out by being face checking that pixel brush. But the power, honestly, the power of Fleeing Panda on this Galio with the Justice Punch and that two-man taunt really sealing the deal there, no?
Yeah, so I think it was just interesting that they just let him lock up. I don't know.
The thing is that our 3v3 is definitely stronger on the top side of the map. So the idea of, like, I think washing hands does get in his own way sometimes where he power ints or chain ints, I would say. It's not power, it's, he just chain ints it sometimes. But to where we have the stronger 3v3 and we're able to do it because of health bars as well.
Yeah.
And Aurelion Soul early game, it just, Fred's point earlier, that's just really, really hard to play that champion early. And if you're not roaming
it finds an angle mid. Taunts him, gets the taunt into the stun, into the other stun. Red buff is not on Maie, though. Fleeing Panda able to flash out to safety. What is the one? I can't remember the name of the rune that gives you the speed boost after using a song.
Nimbus Cloak.
Nimbus Cloak, getting him out of there. Yeah.
I think that was a solid gank overall.
It was definitely a solid gank. I think Maie has always been really, really good about his farm numbers. I've always critiqued Maie since I was doing power rankings when he first came in about his first blood rating, because he kind of just doesn't interact with the lanes and secures his own lead. Wilson is sort of the same with more inting.
The way I've always talked about washing hands ever since he first joined us last split was that he's a great solo queue jungle. He just needs some time in fives where he's not a captain so he can learn fives. Like, he just needs time to learn jungling in fives, and you can see that evolution in this split.
And
gank coming in bot. Maie having to bear himself away. Galio ult coming in hot. Not going to quite connect, but it does bring him into this fight very quick. Hodor Nation is taken out. The taunt clip. Super Hoagie barely lives. DTC Rider on the flank. Gets the three-man massive stun with the Comet of Legend. Has the shutdown.
Nice.
Young Gun alone. Young Gun going to go for the stun. They're going to play around the doctor. Washington's getting the kill, but DTC Rider going to clean up the Leona here. Washington's going in for more barrier. DTC Rider going for the stun. Walks away.
That looks like about it for bot lane. That was a fine play. I mean, it's two for two, right?
Yeah, but with the shutdown, that might as well be three for two.
Oh, no, you're right. It is two for two, yeah. But, you know,
lose drag.
Probably lose drag, lose a plate on top and bot.
That's TP a fair thing. You can't count that.
OG Phil, man. We've seen this quite a few times.
You can't count that. I fucking hate you.
No, you can't count that, dude. Eric's one. This is an island. We don't count that as part of the play.
No, okay. Well, that's fine. So, you lost a play in bot lane, and Jinx lost a lot of fun as well.
Ooh, and look, Fleeing Panda's carrying your team now. It's official.
Look a little risky.
The Galio taunt clipping Super Hoagie, the fight in the river topside, and he just secured first Drake. Fleeing Panda's hard smurfing.
I will tell you this.
Unironically, two of those is actually legit.
No. I'm not disagreeing with you. I will say that when I was drafting my team, I wanted to take Young Gun in the third round where I took Panda. But when I saw that Panda was still up, I knew that he was someone I could count on.
Ooh, big fight here in the top lane. Sinel coming through. Going to be CC'd here. Chain CC. Maie showing excellent patience. He chained the bear stand. Sochi Phil, my ghost and ult going to try and get him out to safety. Clash from Guy Pierre going to help secure the kill. That was really smart from Maie. That was so smart.
That's really good by Maie.
If Eric
just
properly chained the rest of it, I think it was an easier play, but it worked out. Got the ghosts.
Mm-hmm. Got the exhaust out, and there's no level 6 on Hodor right now. If Nocturne, so I will say this. I understand it from both our junglers. Why they want to go the Stridebreaker. I would much rather see Axiom Arc rush, because anybody that you're attacking is not going to be, you know, Sion. So just kill
him. Interesting. Yeah, I'm going to say this. I personally prefer the Bruiser Nocturne build. DTC Rider using that Comet of Legend this time around as we have the four-man gank bot. And the... Tark ult. Good ult.
That's fine.
Okay. No.
You know, I appreciate...
I just wanted to be part of the ult team.
I mean,
you know?
To be fair, they may have seen a Nocturne ult coming. They may have seen a Nocturne ult coming.
So, no. This is what's happening. Julio was didn't know how many people there were. I bet if I asked him, like, why the fuck did you troll an ego? He's like, I didn't know they were all there. Yeah, shut up.
I mean, to be fair, this is something I don't know if you guys were watching the cast game one. That's something I talked about a lot, was like, we don't see DTC Rider making moves around the map with this Aurelion Soul. And that, what did he finally do in the laning phase? And Young Gun, we'll see how well he executes this dive without the Tara Gulp. Mae finds himself a friend.
This is good.
Stun gonna connect onto Young Gun. Young Gun is level 6, no ult available. Oh, gonna get huge. Ooh, hit by the Trompers.
Why are we still trading? Okay, whatever. I guess we
don't know. Galio starting to move down to dissuade any further interaction.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was gonna say about that bot play, like, the bot lane for Bung's OnlyFans was trading. This
could be a solo kill. If he gets the shield pop, the shield disintegrates before he can get it.
Bro, you better walk the fuck away.
Ult is coming up. You know Guy Fieric is thinking it. He wants it so bad.
He's going to whiff the salty as hard as he can.
Nocturne, I hope that we drop Herald bot lane.
Yeah, they should, yeah. Ooh. But Dragon's not up either.
DTC Rider, Juki. Like man.
It's okay.
Galio passive. Low-key. I like playing Galio. Galio passive carries that champion so hard.
This is first tower, actually.
Yeah, this is first tower. So this is really good. This is a great adaptation. That washing hands on the team. I finally
Root. Guy Fieric trying to walk away safely, looking for the stun, doesn't get it. OG Philman juking it. Good ult from Guy Fieric to try and dissuade further action. OG Philman gonna drop a big pit of snow. Nope, walk away. Nocturne chooses Mae, finding new friends left and right. Galio coming in on top. There's the combo. Mae does get clipped by the knockup, runs straight into the Sivir and gets cut off. Ultimate from Young Gun. Clumsy Chocobo gets Hodor Nation. DTC Rider is the next one, and Super Hoagie runs for his life, knowing that fight is doomed the moment that ult gets dropped.
I think my team had Madden earlier saying, guys, group for Kha'Zix, guys, group for Kha'Zix, and there's no Kha'Zix, there's just the Leona ult. So...
Dude, that... I need to see... Someone clip that Leona ult, please. Oh my god, Young Gun with the big guns right there. Holy shit.
Yeah, and honestly, because we used Tarkal before... that fight went badly.
True, yeah. If you would have, if you start Terracolt with that, then we have to wait out in our CC layer. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I mean, we get first tower and second tower bot. It's a tier 2.
Yep.
Washing Hands doing his greedy shit where he's going to clear this wave.
Yup, and Mae hitting the ghost, hitting the bear, hitting the smite, waiting out the spell shield, gets the emote, but that stun delay. Oh, Hodor Nation wanted to try and help, but doesn't quite get it.
Yeah, well, this is drag to the side of FF.
And why is that?
We'll see if they see it.
Can you lay the detail?
Just recall jungle.
Jungle recall. We have the setup here coming in. We see the wards getting placed. We see scrapping top lane. OG Philman getting traded out a lot, but we do see another engage. Leona going in. Tarik dropping that ult immediately as Mae runs in to kind of say, no, me bear. Gets the stun on the Clumsy Chocobo. There's the Young Gun ultimate. Clumsy Chocobo gale forces in, but Super Hoagie is here. Stun gonna land. Nocturne coming through. Young Gun getting chunked out. Hoagie is just free firing and washing hands, though dropping the ult, knows it is better to just avoid the situation. And triple kill for the Mae. You talked about the 1v6, and it is before our very eyes.
I told Matt if he gets fed here, go Blade of the Ring King. So we'll see if he does.
Yeah, well, the only problem with this is that we know Nocturne was in base, and then we take the fight, and then Julio does exactly what he's always done and gets punished for, where he goes in and then he dies. If he plays that fight front to back and actually kills Mae.
There's the miss, but the AoE. Oh, he doesn't go for the grass motto. I think he could have committed. I think he had it. I low-key think he had it. I low-key think Eric had that.
Wait.
Push this wave, what?
They didn't get dragons.
They didn't secure, they were into Nocturne.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, you know what?
Nocturne smited just now. He smited a camp. Yeah. He's pinging his team.
No,
yeah, it's okay. It's okay. This is free.
And it's just Cloud second drag, so...
Well, unpopular opinion...
Yo, second drag, this is important. Like, I think I know where Sean's going. Because it's like, if you see Cloud in the first two drakes, that means it's important. Because it's not going to be a Cloud Soul.
It's a good Drake afterwards. I'm hoping for X-Tech. That's
Cyan's actually...
Yo, why not Chemtech? Low-key? Maya going in, tries to smite the spell shield, washing hands, patient with it, but the stun gonna land from DTC Rider. We see the flank in. Hodor Nation does not have ultimate available. There's no Tarkle. Leona goes in, teleports coming in. Nocturne ult is down. Who does he dive? He dives Hodor Nation, who is dead. DTC Rider ultimate wave is gonna get hit by the knock up from the Galio ult. A big clump of AoEs. Here comes the flash. Young Gun going to go in, hits the stun, but gets killed for it. Maya is still alive. Udyr is a ridiculous champion and perfect for Maya's playstyle. Guy Fieric is here now. And guys, has zero friends, dragon, going to try and get the knockup. Spell shield is down, but the fear is going to keep him away. Guy Fieric is almost certainly going to go down here. Thank you. Okay. And that is a win.
How we chose to fight when bot, when our top laner was bot?
So we get Ocean, which Ocean is actually good for both teams. And it actually benefits FF a whole lot more than it benefits mine.
Yo, if Bung's OnlyFans wins this, does that mean Red Division greater than Blue?
I will actually say this. And
I'm memeing.
Win or loss.
This is a hype series.
Yeah, I agree. This is me. This is exactly what I told my team beforehand. Win or loss, this team is one of the smartest teams in terms of understanding their roles that I know. They all have their int moments, whether it's Julio or Washing Hands, or Julio or Washing Hands. But
that's right. You keep Jonesy's name out of your mouth,
dude. I love Phil.
I love Garfield Juice, man. That's my boy.
He's my second round pick for a reason.
Matt's tilted. Matt's playing like he's tilted. He just showed bot for no reason. Well, Harold's up.
Yeah, he's looking for something to do.
Yeah, so he should be looking for Harold to do.
As Hodor Nation gonna go for the stun, get spell shielded. Here comes Maya. They have the spell shield down. Gets the Gale Force and the Flash. Nocturne ult is up. Maya says, time to run.
I love it.
Hodor Nation is dead. Tank too many tower shots. Here comes the Sivir ult. The run in. Sion is here now. Jinx Rocket doesn't quite connect. Sion gonna get a multi-man ult. Maya is here still. DTC Rider. Use the ult for a little bit of extra disengage. Not quite having enough damage to finish off these kills.
Can I just be honest? Singe go burn, dude. Like, that boy just runs. But there were
just good, but Eric didn't hit the full charge Q, and it was just like that made it fall apart.
That's unfortunate for sure. I do think that in some ways that Beagoth could have not committed to the fight. Now we do get two kills out of it, which is fine. But you just need to use the Nocturne ulti to save the Sivir, and then once that's done, you can finish it. But you know, kudos to them for committing. It's also another thing that I really like about this team is that they do commit, even if sometimes I'm like, this is not the time to commit, but they commit. So
well, I guess you look at my team too, and where are their deaths? Like, if they're not on the carries at all, it's like,
oh no, Hoagie's still in a position to carry.
Yep,
Hoagie's still in a position to carry. I think
is Night Harvester what you go on Aurelion Soul?
A lot of people do.
Okay, I'm just like, that's very interesting, because that's an item you don't see too often unless you're like an assassin like Elise or maybe Echo. But even then, like, protobelt's also better sometimes, a lot of the times. But it's hard to see it on, like, a control. It's weird you see it on a control mage champion like Aurelion Soul.
So I will say that with Aurelion Soul players, I've seen a lot of non-mythics until third or fourth item.
Mm-hmm.
Because they'll go the Rylai's into, like, demonic. And then sometimes if they're, like, really wanting to do it, like, in some ways I think it might be beneficial this game for them to do Imperial Mandate, where you can amplify the other people's damage, which is incredibly...
and if you don't need a mythic as a core item to make your champion work.
Yeah. Yeah, because that's the problem with Aurelion Soul, why he's not really seen that much, except for, like, the people who are one-tricks, because his mythic is kind of weird. I think maybe Crown can work for him. I've seen Everfrost before, and then Leandre's. Those are the main three that I've usually seen.
Depends on the matchup. I think here this Nightharvester is not bad at all. I mean, like, it does damage that we need. I know he's gonna go second item Zhonya's, it already looks like, which is good into the Nocturne comp. Give him time just sitting there.
Oh. So, setting up for drag here.
Set up for bot lane.
Yeah, we're not set up for drag a minute and a half.
A minute and a half before.
Well, they were sitting.
So we also have Harold in our back pocket. So if Singe is not a part of this. So this is something that I hope everybody does this. I want all teams to learn this. When you're up two or three dragons, but primarily two, because by the time that the third one comes around, if you're taking them upon spawn, it's around the 18 to 20 minute mark.
That's a Baron angle.
Yeah, it's usually not, it, like, you probably can't do Baron unless you're super snowballing, right? With like a bunch of gold in your wallet. But what you can look to do is trade on the opposite side of the map. So like a Herald in top lane, getting that tower and maybe the inhib, or vice versa in bot lane, is better.
Speaking of Baron, yeah, but they know that they put that Bogoff's has been playing for these dragons all game. Guy Fieri, I gotta see Sin's gonna face check into this. Yep, and here we go. OG Philman gotta get hit by the zap here. The stun from Hodor Nation is not gonna connect. Bear co burr, but Sin slow go burr harder. Dabbing
OG
penguins
actually saved the game right there. I'm not even lying, because they can do that. It takes about 20 seconds, but that is a free Baron with the likes of Terry. Mm-hmm. Right there.
Mm-hmm.
So,
all right,
here.
Yep, here comes the Rift Herald. We're gonna have a siege mid. Hodor Nation, does he have enough mana for this ultimate right now? He has no mana right now, and they're moving forward without mana on their Taric. Oh, Mae?
You have no mana, freak.
Oh.
We just need. Okay, I hope they learned what I was trying to teach them.
All right, looks like the trade is mid tower for the dragon.
He's trading into mid tower.
Fleeing Panda gonna try and stop him. He is a Galio. He's gonna be tanker. There's the stun coming through. They're not fighting underneath this mid tower. Galio's gonna get knocked out before he can do anything. Julio, Clumsy Chocobo gets knocked up. One, two. Clumsy Chocobo is the next one down. Here comes Ochi Philman. Young Gun not gonna quite connect for the stun, but does get the slow. Nocturne has gotten the ult. Here he comes. Ulting in. Is it enough? Get stunned immediately. And there's another 1,000 gold shutdown onto the Jinx. Young Gun gonna go in. Here, Aurelion Soul doing so much damage. Guy Fieri gonna flash and get the shield proc. Currently 4-3. OG Philman dodges the stuns, but can he dodge to save his life? Yes, he does. And that is quite a decent gold swing into the pockets of Jinx. Finishing that Runance after that fight.
That kill to Jinx is such a bad thing for Fung's only.
And why is that?
At the same time, well, the fact is, if Jinx gets really fed and doesn't die in the fight, it's kind of over, because she's been free hitting a lot. Team comp is really tanky. And she's got the Enchanter. Like, they scale up super hard. Mm-hmm. So it's just a matter of stopping this fourth dragon.
Imagine if they had mana on Taric, too, in that fight.
Yeah, if they had mana on Taric, that's a different fight. I think they just solidly win it, instead of just kind of sweeping it out.
I'll say this. You were kind of gifted by my fucking jungler for deciding to ult the Udyr. The what? Like, he's a tank. Stop this, child.
Oh, Young Gun. Oh, Hodor Nation almost hitting the flash stun there.
Oh, we should go on this. Please.
Oh, here we go. Looks like we might be. Here comes the ult. Young Gun gonna get the ult there. Here comes the Taric ult as well. Doesn't get finished in time. Here's the dive comp in action. Mae trying to run away. Stun gonna land. They're fighting into this choke. Gets ulted back into the choke. Stun taunt going to land on the two members. They are running them down. It is a triple kill for Clumsy Chocobo. Do we see four posted to the page as we go for the tower and the inhibitor here? It could be game here, friends. This could be the finals for Bung's only fans. He only has five of them. Keep that in mind as they take down the inhibitor here. 10 seconds left. Hodor Nation is up. Sorry, 13 seconds, 12 seconds. Hoagie is up in 10 seconds. Do they get the end of the game? Taric gets a three-man stun, but Sivir is still free-firing. There's the taunt. Hodor Nation is dead. Here we go. Jinx is alive. Udyr is alive. Texas Tower is going down. They're tanking the towers for a lot. Young Gun is going to go down. Jinx is excited. Mae is chasing him down. Walking through the sin slow. Not going to help him out here. Here comes a big Aurelion Soul. Ghost is activated by Mae. Going to get the stun. Gets flipped. They're running them down. Mae has to run away to safety. OG Philman trying to chase him down. And they have an open Nexus. But their playoffs dreams are still alive on the side of Fudgy's feeders.
Holy shit. That's all I have to say. I'm way ahead of you, buddy. You know what? TM's casting
hype.
So much on the line is amazing.
I think, dude.
Yeah.
I think
you're welcome.
Just troll. Like, you sent Eric to bottom lane, and then he never rotated for the play. We know they have Sivir, right? Just group at this point. If your team's showing too hard like that.
I do think the only problem is, like, so this was the reason why I was okay, why we were okay with banning the Gnar. Because, like, obviously, Eric is, like, extremely comfortable, very good at him, and he provides a lot more like, damage and utility at the same time. But if he goes his Hullbreaker build.
Oh, the Jinx
Sion,
Rocket is down.
I didn't want to pick Sion here. I'm going to say that.
Yo, hey, let's not put our team members down here as we see Guy Fieri holding down the mid lane. This Baron is now half health. They know they're starting it.
Leona needs to be marking right now, but they'll get this for free. It's free.
Yeah, so that is a Baron going the way of... Excuse me, going the way of Bung's only fans.
Yeah, I think my team's just going to be on defense until that inhib comes back up, and then they can feel a little more safe.
Yeah.
It's not like a huge split push threat.
You're 100% right. Yeah, we're going to be grouping because we're just a five-man death ball, and Galio plays in the adjacent lane because he didn't ult in. Again, Jinx is very close to IE. Can we tab over for gold, please?
Yeah.
Okay.
When that IE hits, it is the Hoagie Show. It's the Hoagie Shogi.
Yeah, it's the Hoagie Shogi Show. Cramp. All right.
Well, Ocean Soul is up in 20 seconds.
Has never had to play football.
Is that true?
I mean, like, sometimes you play behind me early, but by 26 minutes, we usually had.
Yeah, I will tell you this. So, opposite of that, my team always throws because Popo lives on.
The dream still lives.
So you have that.
All right, we have a siege coming in here, top lane. The wave, decentish wave clear.
Yeah, Aurelion, Gull, and Jinx are really, really good. I really wish that Galio would be bot lane, or possibly even Singed. Yeah, now they're going to check it out. Yeah.
Well, so now I think my team can't engage here. They have no mana, no HP.
Yeah, your only form of engage is Aurelion Soul, Udyr running at you, or the really, really strong guy running at you. So running at you is definitely not like the best engage.
Oh, Nocturne ulting in, sees Hodor Nation is alone. Targle coming through, gonna keep three members of his team alive. Tark is still alive, Fleeing Panda taking very low. Maia is now here, Hodor Nation is down. Going to run him down, Fleeing Panda very low, but the locket keeps him alive. OG Philman is here, Super Hoagie gets flipped into the team. Galio ult, this is it. This is the end for Fudgy's Feeders, and the 3 seed moves on to the finals. Bung's Only Fans goes to finals.
I will say that this was one of the harder teams to play against in terms of prepping. Good job to Fudgy's Feeders, man. Like, absolutely love it. We beat Maya and Udyr, which is not a lot of team with things that people can say. So there you go.
I'm just gonna stand by the Udyr pick was good. I think I just hit the bet on top lane.
No, I think the Udyr pick is good. I think you kind of lack engage is the only thing.
Yeah, I think it was just like a Malphite ended.
Yeah, Malphite would have been pretty good. Yeah, because there's just a go button, and then since we won a group, you won a group, right? But you also didn't know that we had Sivir until pick 5, so.
Yeah, GG's, close game. I'm gonna go talk to my team. We're gonna go hang out.
Yeah, same as well.
All right, and we're going to have a player of the series votes here, a POTS vote. Who would you guys say is player of the series really quick before you leave? Oh, I think they left. Tragedy. Chat, who do you think is player of the series as I put this together here? Clumsy Chocobo and... Young Gun 18. Create poll. Share. Washing hands when he doesn't int. True! Alright, there is the player of the series poll. Vote for your person. I think Fleeing Panda deserves some shoutouts. I thought his game 2 performance, he had a huge CS lead and set up a lot of really good zones, made a lot of good plays, and Washing Hands would run it down. But I mean, the story of the series was that matchup between Maya and Washing Hands. Washing Hands popping off game 2, and then game 3, the Nocturne ults were strong. But I think it's hard to say because, like, yes, Nocturne is 11-1 and 15. But Galio won them the river fight. Galio won them the bot fight that really snowballed that game out of control.
See, I think my player of the series is actually Fleeing Panda now that I think about it. We see three votes for Young Gun. Hello. All right, currently tied between Washing Hands and Young Gun. Make sure you vote here, folks. There are 24 people in this chat and only 7 votes. Come on, more than 7 people vote. I'm going to drop the link again. One more vote at least to break this tie. Do we have any more votes? Oh, Young Gun taking it. Young Gun, player of the series. Get on up here into the player of the series chat. Player of the game chat. Player of the game won. If you are watching Young Gun, the tie has been broken in your favor. Get up here. Hello.
Hello.
What's it feel like? Player of the series, going to finals.
Yeah, man. It's really cool. I've been player of the series almost every series we played. This is just the first time on paper that it's actually happened.
I see.
Yeah. It's cool. I'm not a support player, so this is really exciting for me.
What do you usually play?
Dota 2.
True. Yeah,
but when I play League of Legends, I'm usually either a mid or a jungler. But you know, it is what it is. I've learned a lot over the last couple week or couple of last few games about. Turns out overwhelming aggression on supports. Tend to win games, so
it can indeed it can. And I see Washington Ant saying Dota 2 superior game. I hate to agree, but so really quick going into the series, you guys lost game two. What were you guys worried going into game three?
We lost game one.
Oh yeah, it was the reverse sweep. Yeah, well, so what was the combo like?
We've kind of, our signature has been kind of high damage, snowball-y teams, right? Put a higher damage carrying jungler or something that can roll into the mid game and we don't allow their ADC to get online.
Mm-hmm.
Or we just kill their ADC over and over and over if they are online.
Mm-hmm.
And then, it.
We're not sharing team secrets, are we?
No.
Okay.
I'm sorry, Sean. You are not player of the series. You are not of a caliber. This is a only semifinals player of the series here, chat. As the fellow player of the series last night, I understand, Young Gun. You know your coach can.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is your safe place to talk shit about Sean if you want.
No, there's. This, I don't
know. I'm kidding.
But you know, and he talks about sharing team secrets. They can't ban us out. We play so many champions. Good fucking luck. You know.
You know, honestly, same.
So.
Yeah, I definitely understand that, and I can, you know, looking at your team and prepping that, talking that shit about me.
I will.
So,
No, he was like, the real secret is, you know, he was like, I like robots. You know, Blitzcrank mm-hmm. is a great champion. You know, you're really good at him. But he goes, I'm a ginger. Leona's a ginger. I want to be represented. So that's why.
True.
I play Leona. Yes.
True. Sean is red haired. Yes.
So representation matters, Sean. I will continue to play Leona as long as you'll pick her for me.
Oh, jeez. All right. Really quick, looking ahead, you are up against, and I'm coming as a caster. You are up against Hmong next week. You guys played against each other, went 1-1 in the first week of the season. No team secrets or any of that stuff, but like, what are your thoughts going into this match, or going into finals in your first split of PMA LCS?
Well, aren't we the only team that they dropped a game to?
We also dropped a game to EDG.
Okay. Well, we beat EDG, didn't we?
I don't know.
So, point is, it doesn't matter. You know, we're gonna work our game plan. You know.
What is that game plan? I have a notepad here just for you know. I'm kidding. Good, okay, keep going.
No. Cool. I'm gonna go mid. We're gonna send.
Hell yeah.
We're gonna send Julio to the jungle. Wilson's actually.
You know what? You might have some less inting.
He's got a work conference that week, so we're gonna bring up
I feel like your TM could jungle, right? I hear he plays jungle.
Let Sean jungle, and then I don't know. Maybe I won't show up at all. I am gonna be on a laptop next week. I didn't plan to be this far into the service tournament.
Sean, you accept this lack of confidence on your team? Yeah, real talk, if it's Sean and me jungling against each other, it's fiddlesticks every game. No one has fun. Zero people have fun.
You know, and this is the big secret. People keep not banning out our supports, but they haven't even seen my support Galio or my support my support Singed. I've run a support Talon before. You know, all of these off-meta things that don't work, I'm very good at. So,
yeah, awesome. That's very exciting. Well, congrats on the series, congrats on the finals, and congrats on Player of the Series.
Thank you.
Yeah. Well, good luck
again,
next.
I've been Player of the Series every series, but you know.
Yeah. I get it.
The secret is that Wilson votes for himself, and then so does Panda. So.
I voted for Panda this time. That was me.
Yep. So. Well, yeah, thank you. So I'll be looking forward to having this exact same interview next week.
Sadly, I will be crying. So, yeah. Well, GG's fun series tonight. Thank you all for tuning in. I am Sarah Cruz. This is PMA LCS. And thank you.
All right, have a good one.
For coming here. Bye-bye. Let me find the stop stream button.